Chapter 3761, Holy Land. A group of women in short jackets and skirts walked over. They were slender, with their long legs fully exposed, looking somewhat inappropriate. Long Chen smiled when he saw them. This was the spirit race that he was familiar with, the elven spirit race. He had encountered them in the mortal world and had fought alongside them. Hence, he naturally felt close to them. Their leader was a woman, looking to be around 30 years old. However, she also seemed to be like a young maiden, full of vitality. She was actually a divine venerate. "I am Long Chen. Greetings, senior." Long Chen bowed to her. "You are too courteous. I wouldn't dare to accept being called senior. I am Jin Yi. You can just call me by my name." The divine venerate returned Long Chen's bow courteously. "You mentioned the devil eye world just now. What is that?" asked Long Chen. "It will take a while to explain it. I can't leave my important guests waiting out here. Why don't you come to my spirit race's holy land for a chat?" Jin Yi gestured invitingly. Long Chen didn't really want to go to this so-called holy land. He only wanted to use their land to rush to the heavenly river Blun Sea. Fortunately, this place was one end of their territory, and the heavenly river Blood Sea was closer to the other side. A trip to their holy land shouldn't take too much time. Furthermore, she had invited him. Not going would be rude. Moreover, Long Chen still had the ultra-transportation formation discs that Xia Chen had given him. He would be able to use them within the spirit race's territory. There should be enough time. Even if he wasted a few days, it should be enough to get there in time. Long Chen and Jiang Lei walked deeper into the forest with Jin Yi. As for the two girls, they narrated how brave Long Chen and Jiang Lei had been to these elven spirit women and how they had killed the baddies. The two of them were described as reincarnations of celestial beings. Jin Yi told Long Chen that the devil experts had only been passing by here. That was the only reason they had suddenly launched an attack. Within the 3,000 worlds, the devil race occupied several territories. In particular, the devil eye world only appeared in certain locations occasionally, usually deep within their forbidden lands. But this time, the devil eye world was descending not far from the spirit race's territory, and those devil experts were unable to directly use a transportation formation. They had to travel on foot to get there. It just so happened that some of them were crossing through this region. Thus, they set their sights on the spirit race and launched a sneak attack, conveniently grabbing a few benefits before leaving. Also, the spirit race was in the midst of carrying out a grand ceremony, and their people were gathered in their core territory. When the outer region was suddenly attacked, Jin Yi immediately rushed over to reinforce them, but she was too late. Everything was already over when she arrived. Now that the devil eye world was about to open, the devil race wouldn't attack them temporarily. Jin Yi felt confident in bringing everyone back. "Can I ask what the devil eye world is?" asked Long Chen. "The devil eye world can be considered an underground spring. As the 3,000 worlds was one of the main battlefields of the immemorial battle, countless terrifying existences are buried within it. Although those existences have died, their power has not fully dissipated. Instead, it merged into heaven and earth. Every time there is a change in the world, these energies are released. Whether it is to the natives or the experts from outside this world, these are huge opportunities. But then, competing for these opportunities is a natural tribulation. The strong survive, while the dead become their stepping stones to higher heights. Some terrifying experts always appear at these moments. At the same time, countless life forms die. Fortunately, all the major races within the 3,000 worlds are at equilibrium and restrained by each other. Although there are countless battles, there are no entire annihilations of a race. It's just unknown how long this equilibrium can last, sighed Jin Yi worriedly. Equilibrium? The human race doesn't even have a single territory forbidden to other races. How is that equal? The human race within the 3,000 worlds has practically been turned into dogs. But I suppose it is a miracle that they haven't been wiped out after so many years, said Longchen irritably as soon as he thought of his own race bullying their own people. The human race's decline is due to living too long in the cracks of other races. It is like living on the edge of an abyss, as if treading on thin ice. Because of it, their guts shrink more and more. They've already lost their fighting spirit, said Jin Yi. No, they haven't lost their fighting spirit. Whenever they see humans coming from outside this world, they have plenty of fighting spirit. Long Chen curled his lips. Jin Yi smiled. My spirit race won't criticize the human race. But your comment has hit the nail on the head. The human race chose to put their safety above all else. As they don't dare to resist the oppression of the major powers, they can only endure. As long as the other side doesn't declare war on the human race, they won't provoke anyone. After a long time, the major powers found that the human race was not enough of a threat to them. Most importantly, the human race could help them with some things. What things? Jin Yi hesitated to answer after hearing Long Chen's question. Long Chen asked, it couldn't be that they are being spies, helping other races to keep an eye on the human race. Perhaps not just surveillance. The human race in the 3,000 worlds is actually the greatest danger to the humans coming from outside this world. It's unknown how many heroes of the human race were silently killed by their own race, sighed Jin Yi. Upon hearing this, Long Chen's heart pounded with fury. Zia Yuhong had told him to be careful of the human race. He had been prepared, but hearing this, it seemed that the human race was even worse than he had thought. No wonder those two girls thought that I was a bad person. It seems that your race has endured quite a bit at the hands of the human race. Long Chen sighed. Jin Yi smiled. The human race has good and bad points. We won't judge any race as good or bad, so don't feel bad or feel responsible. I'm only telling you these things so that you know of the danger. Don't get harmed by your own race. Many thanks for the reminder. Long Chen had experienced countless battles and had seen all kinds of people. It wasn't easy to trick him, but he was still enraged just at the thought. Those that could make him lower his guard were essentially kind people. Yet, a group of evil humans actually used the human race's kindness and trust to strip away other people's lives. Long Chen was so angry that he wanted to kill them all. As they were speaking, they arrived at an ancient altar. Jin Yi then clasped her hands in devout prayer. Na Valun, come after that. The altar quivered, and space shook. Long Chen felt a gentle spatial energy wrap around him. When that happened, the surrounding space grew illusory. They entered a space-time channel. In all his years, it was his first time experiencing such a transportation formation. Furthermore, the transportation energy was completely different from others. When the transportation ended, Long Chen and Jiang Lei saw countless figures devoutly praying while kneeling on the ground. Looking in the direction they were praying, Long Chen's body suddenly shook intensely. He couldn't believe his eyes. It's her. Chapter 3762. Once more seeing the mysterious woman, this beautiful woman's divine radiance lit up the entire world. Countless experts of the spirit race were kowtowing to her. This was not Long Chen's first time seeing her. This was a woman who caused him heartache, and yet he didn't recognize her. On the martial heaven continent, Long Chen saw her in the heaven dragon flame region, and she transmitted the Nirvana scripture to him. In the Brahma secret realm, he once more encountered her and obtained the sixth star's pill formula for the nine-star hegemon body art. When Long Chen saw this woman, A certain memory resurfaced in his mind. You are you, you are not you. You are one, you are not one. Nine stars against the heavens. The heavens collapse, gods fall, and blood dyes the sky red. The peak of power, the peak of the Tao. To defy the heavens, is this the final result? When she said these words back then, it was like she was speaking right into his ear. His vision changed. It felt like he was returning to the Brahma secret realm. Long Chen could clearly see a beautiful figure in front of him. It was illusory, but it was that woman. She looked at Long Chen with familiarity. Her gaze seemed to pierce through to his core. It was warm, gentle, and loving. She was a peerless beauty and held endless emotion in her. When she looked at Long Chen, her eyes were tender. Why must you do this? The woman opened her mouth. Long Chen couldn't hear her voice, but he understood what she was saying. She just stood there in front of Long Chen, yet he couldn't sense her existence. The two of them seemed to be looking at each other through endless space-time. Without being aware of it, tears streamed down Long Chen's face. He didn't know who she was, but for some reason, every time he saw her, he was filled with heartache. That pain was like blades slashing and twisting through him. Long Chen wanted to hug her and cry, but he knew that the person in front of him didn't exist anymore. You are you, you are not you. To throw yourself back into the tribulation of the 10 worlds, why bother? She once more spoke, because I want to save you. Long Chen spoke all of a sudden. Even he didn't know why he would say such a thing. It seemed as if the woman heard him. As a result, tears dripped down her face and she slowly smiled. You are still so stubborn, so domineering. Fine. Even if we are consigned to eternal damnation, I will accompany you. Suddenly, this vision vanished. Her figure, superimposed on top of the woman the spirit race was praying to. The two of them were one and the same. They had evoked Long Chen's memories. At this moment, this woman was an illusion. However, she was still enveloped by divine light. As they prayed, faith energy thrummed. Long Chen could sense a gentle energy coming from the spirit race's experts and entering that woman's figure. That woman's divine radiance also basked them in its light. It was a strange cycle. Jin Yi and the others who had come with her were already kneeling, praying toward the woman. Of everyone present, only Long Chen and Jiang Lei were standing. Long Chen stared at the woman foolishly. He clearly didn't know her, but just looking at her filled him with grief and sorrow. He did his best to remember, digging through his memories, but he was unable to remember who she was. As everyone prayed, the divine light surrounding the woman grew denser. She gradually grew solid and opened her eyes. She looked at Long Chen. Warm light came from her eyes, and she smiled at him. At this moment, time and space seemed to freeze. Everything else within heaven and earth faded. All that remained was Long Chen and the woman. She slowly walked down from the heavens. When she reached out her hand and caressed Long Chen's cheek, heartache filled her face. You've suffered so much. Your path was difficult. For some reason, hearing her voice almost made Long Chen collapse into tears. It was as if this was the woman who understood him the best in this world. She knew everything that he experienced and knew how tired he was. However, he remained stubborn and did his best to retain his rationality. He said, I'm not afraid of bitterness. I'm not afraid of being tired. But I am afraid of loss. It's like I've lost so many things, and I want them all back. Can you tell me if I've lost some of my memories? I clearly feel so familiar with you, but I don't remember you. It's a painful feeling, said Long Chen. He was choked with sobs toward the end. For some reason, he suddenly thought of Yu Qingxuan. Yu Qingxuan had also lost her previous memories. He wanted to know if he was the same as Yu King Chuan. The woman looked at Long Chen warmly. She softly said, "People born in this world gain and lose something. No matter how high your cultivation base, no matter how powerful you are, some things simply can't be forced." "I don't believe it. I ultimately believe that as long as my power exceeds the laws, I can control everything. If I cannot, it only proves that I'm not strong enough. Perhaps I can't do it right now, but one day I will definitely be able to create my own world with freedom. I will live free with the people I love." Long Chen shook his head and spoke firmly. The woman's body quivered ever so slightly. A trace of pain appeared in her eyes, and her smile became a bit bitter. "You did say such things. Even after experiencing countless tribulations, your determination remained unshaken. You are still him." "Who am I?" asked Long Chen. The woman sighed. "Who you are isn't important. As long as you think that you are you, that is enough. Tell me, do you like the spirit race?" "I do," answered Long Chen without hesitation. "Why?" "There's no why. I just like them." "If you must have an answer, I'd say it's because their hearts are the final pure place in this world. As long as they exist, this world still has hope," said Long Chen. The woman suddenly smiled. She looked very happy. She warmly cleaned up Long Chen's somewhat messy hair. "But there are still differences. You are you, he is him. I'm very happy. Who are you? What is our connection? Can you really not tell me?" Long Chen couldn't help asking. "Who I am isn't important. Our connection isn't important. What is important is that your heart is pure as well. I am at ease. Now, I should transmit the true Nirvana scripture to you." The woman smiled widely. She slowly pressed a hand on Long Chen's forehead, and countless runes flowed into his mind. See Chapter 3763, 5th volume of the Nirvana scripture. One rune after another was deeply imprinted into Long Chen's mind. What shocked Long Chen was that these runes were ones that he was familiar with. They were from the first volume of the Nirvana scripture. Every rune gave off a different sound. But when they entered his mind this time, he found that some of them were giving off a different sound than before. Previously, when he chanted the Nirvana scripture, the scripture was gentle. It was holy and sacred, but not domineering. Now that the sound of these runes had changed, they contained more of a feeling of ordering the heavens, a domineeringness to force the world to obey. The first volume, the second volume, the third volume, the fourth volume. These were all scriptures that he had previously learned. After the fourth scripture, a new scripture that he had never encountered before entered his mind. The fifth volume of the Nirvana scripture. Long Chen was delighted. He never had a chance to learn the fifth volume, and he hadn't expected to encounter it here. When those runes rang out in Long Chen's mind, his body quivered in pain. It was like violent lava was exploding throughout his bones. It was like he was going to explode. Long Chen was delighted by this. This fifth volume had changed the gentle scripture. It was now explosive. The first four volumes were like a babbling creek, gentle and tranquil, nourishing all life. But the fifth volume was like a raging flood, an angry tsunami destroying the world. Long Chen wasn't even circulating the fifth volume of the Nirvana scripture. Just listening to it already caused his body to feel uncomfortable. He couldn't help being shocked. How was the fifth volume of the Nirvana scripture so violent? It seems that there's no way to use the fifth volume before advancing to the Immortal King realm. Otherwise, its power will directly kill me. Sensing the Nirvana scripture, feeling the immense power within every syllable, Long Chen grew even more reverent of the Nirvana scripture. Finally, the scripture faded and Long Chen slowly opened his eyes. He looked at the beautiful woman before him. This woman also looked at Long Chen. She smiled. Remember your words. Protect the purity in your heart. After saying that, she kissed Long Chen on the forehead. Her body slowly faded away, and the figure in the sky vanished with her. A rain of divine light fell. As the spirit races experts piously kowtowed, the rain of light blessed them. They smiled quietly. The spirit race really is a grand race. I'm a selfish person, but even I feel the urge to sacrifice my life to protect them. Looking at the endless life forms of the spirit race, feeling their holy and kind auras, Jiang Lei couldn't help sighing. Every kind life form should be treated warmly. However, many times, kindness is not repaid. It isn't fair. That Lai Chenggeng, he said something I like. Reading books is to comprehend reason, and cultivating is to talk reason with others. Against people who don't talk reason, all your profound principles and explanations are useless. You will never be able to wake up people who are faking sleep, said Long Chen. If we can't wake them up, we'll make sure that they will never get a chance to wake up, said Jiang Lei. Long Chen smiled. That was precisely what he was thinking. Previously, he wanted to protect the human race. But now he understood. What he wanted to protect was not the human race. It was kindness. It had nothing to do with race. The void quivered slightly. A white-haired lean elder then appeared before Long Chen and bowed slightly toward him. I was in the midst of worshipping my god and receiving my god's blessing just now. I'm sorry for being late. Please forgive me. Long Chen hastily returned the bow. Senior is too courteous. I'm Long Chen. I urgently wish to go to the Heavenly River Blood Sea, and I am hoping to cross the Spirit Race's territory to travel there. Is it convenient for me to do so? You are the most esteemed guest of our Spirit Race. You saved us from crisis several times, so giving you passage is a minor matter. I am not skilled enough to protect all the Spirit Race's lifeforms within the 3,000 worlds despite leading them, causing these children to suffer. Fortunately, you are kind enough to save us. I received the God's guidance just now to come and see you. If you need anything, just ask. My spirit race might be weak, but all of our members are willing to go through hell for you, said the elder sincerely. Senior, it's not so serious. Right now, we just wish to reach the Heavenly River Blood Sea as quickly as possible. Hopefully, we can get through before the demonic beasts finish their blockade, said Long Chen. The Heavenly River Blood Sea is filled with blood Kai, and your blood Kai is astonishing. Undergoing tribulation, there is definitely the best choice for you. The elder nodded. Senior, do you know the origin of the Heavenly River Blood Sea? Asked Long Chen. The Heavenly River Blood Sea was one of the main battlefields of the immemorial battle. Back then, 1 billion beast venerates surrounded 3,000 nine-star heirs. In the end, both sides were wiped out. After they died, their soul essence remained. Their fighting spirits did not extinguish, so they continue to fight even now. It is a land of death. A bloody river rages above a bloody sea. That is the result of the wills of the nine-star heirs, and the beast venerates still fighting even after so many years. As a result, experts with powerful physical bodies will undergo tribulation inside to absorb the energy of the blood sea. The stronger the person, the more of that energy that they can absorb, and thus the greater the benefits. The Heavenly River Blood Sea surges whenever the 3,000 worlds and the 9 heavens and 10 lands link up. That is when its power is at its peak and the best time to undergo tribulation inside. Calculating the time, it should be close to this moment, said the elder. 1 billion beast venerates against 9-star heirs? Long Chen was shocked. Yes. It was 1 billion divine venerates of the beast race against 3,000 divine venerate 9-star heirs. They all died in the end, leaving the heavenly river Blood Sea in their wake, said the elder. 3,000 against 1,000,000,000, ending with both sides dying? As expected of the strongest warriors of the 9 heavens and 10 lands, praised Jiang Lei. However, he didn't know that his boss was precisely a 9-star heir. What level of battle armor did those 9-star heirs activate? Long Chen couldn't help asking. The elder shook his head apologetically. I'm sorry. I only inherited a portion of memories from the previous generation. Furthermore, the last generation leader didn't experience that battle. Thus, no one knows the exact details. Senior, I want to go to the Heavenly River Blood Sea now. I'll bid you farewell, said Long Chen, in a rush to leave. He wanted to get to the bottom of the Heavenly River Blood Sea. He couldn't wait any longer. Then, let me send you on your way. The elder suddenly vanished. Long Chen and Jiang Lei found that the world in front of them was changing. Those spirit race experts all vanished, and Long Chen and Jiang Lei appeared within an endless starry sky. An unending forest raced past them beneath their feet. From this viewpoint, they were seeing practically the entire territory of the spirit race. Long Chen was shocked. Unexpectedly, this elder was an absolutely enormous tree. However, Long Chen very quickly rejected this theory. They weren't standing on top of the leaves of a tree. They were standing atop the leaf of a golden vine. At this moment, the golden vine lit up. Long Chen and Jiang Lei cried out, shooting out of the vine. The void twisted. When they saw where they were, they found that they had reached the edge of the spirit race's territory. Chapter 3764, Land of Buried Corpses, Respected Guests, I can only send you this far. I wish you good fortune. The elder bowed to Long Chen. Long Chen hastily returned the bow. I truly have to thank you. This single transportation had saved him at least half a month. That was of immense help. When the elder left, Long Chen took out the map. He found that this place was only 3 days away from the Heavenly River Blood Sea. Boss, I don't understand. The spirit race clearly has so many terrifying existences. Why are they willing to be bullied by others? Asked Jiang Lei. Even if Jiang Lei counted out the elder who had brought them here, in their prayer land, he had seen at least hundreds of divine venerates. There were also many supreme experts, so he didn't understand this. The spirit race has many branches within, and some of them don't dare to touch the air of death. They would rather die than kill someone. There are also some that are immensely powerful and possess killer divine abilities. They won't be the slightest bit merciful. For example, the stone spirit race, the elven spirit race, and also some of the giant humanoid races. They are all not afraid of being exposed to the resentment air of death. However, killing for too long will cause them to gradually grow irritable. Their inner hearts will no longer be pure. Thus, they will intermittently find those pure-hearted members of the spirit race to help them cleanse that irritable chi within them. That will prevent them from becoming bloodthirsty devils. In truth, the spirit race has kind spirits and evil spirits. We've only encountered the kind ones so far. It is said that the evil spirits were corrupted experts of the spirit race who became violent and bloodthirsty. The only way for them to drain off that desire is to kill. To put it frankly, it is the result of suppressing and accumulating darkness within themselves for too long. Once it erupts, it turns them into a devil. They can never be pure again, said Long Chen. Jiang Lei suddenly said, I remember. I was chased down by a humanoid ominous spirit. At that time, I was in the Four Peak Realm and powerless to resist. But just as its wooden arrow stabbed through my body, it said something incomprehensible to me. I didn't understand what it was saying at all, and then it let me go. But all the members of the human race in that area were killed by it. Now that I think back to it, perhaps it only didn't kill me because I had the mark of the spirit race on me. That means its inner heart wasn't fully devoured yet. It still retained some. Long Chen's body suddenly quivered. He was about to say that its inner heart still retained some kindness. That was the pure land in its heart. Thinking of that, he thought of what the woman told him. Is it because I called the spirit race's kindness as a pure land that she transmitted the Nirvana scripture to me? Long Chen felt an indescribable feeling toward that mysterious woman. Sometimes that feeling was clear, but sometimes it was vague. It was like there was a tie inside his soul that could solve this riddle, but no matter how he tried to grasp it, he couldn't. Have you recovered to your peak condition? Asked Long Chen. During the prayer, the divine light fully healed me, said Jiang Lei. Good. Prepare to have a terrible battle. Let's go. Long Chen and Jiang Lei headed straight toward the heavenly river Blood Sea. They didn't bother concealing their presence. After flying for a day, the pungent scent of blood filled the air, and strange energy currents began to appear in the void. Space was no longer completely stable. This isn't good. Boss, it seems that this space will not allow transportation talismans to be used. Jiang Lei's expression changed. Xia Chen's transportation formations were life-saving treasures. They hadn't even reached the heavenly river Blood Sea yet, but this trump card was already lost. You're right. But since we've come, we can only barge in. Don't worry, it is too big for the demonic beasts to fully block it. Furthermore, the core region will only allow divine lords to enter once it starts to surge. Those elders won't be able to interfere. It is very difficult for the demonic beasts to guard such a huge area, and the human race also has experts with powerful physical bodies. Can they really block them all? Long Chen wasn't worried. They continued flying. At this moment, the ground began to change color. Blood-colored currents appeared. Long Chen even saw the mouth of a spring. Liquid was coming out of it just like fresh blood from underground. Rivers flowed toward the core. Long Chen then reached out and lifted a handful of this blood-colored liquid. He sniffed it and suddenly reached back into the liquid. The earth quivered and cracks spread. As Long Chen increased his power, the earth bulged. An enormous existence was forcibly ripped out of the ground. It was an enormous skeleton. It looked to be a winged dragon. However, its tail was not in the right proportion. Its tip was sharp, and it even had a coccyx the shape of a palm leaf. Long Chen didn't recognize this life form. The skeleton was decaying and filled with holes like a honeycomb. But there were still many runes emitting a powerful aura despite the encroachment of time. It probably isn't an ordinary divine venerate. Long Chen was shaken when he sensed this aura. It had been millions and millions of years. However, the corpse still existed, and its runes were intact. That meant that the master of this corpse was a supremely terrifying existence. Long Chen then tossed the corpse into the primal chaos space's black soil. However, he was disappointed. After it was devoured, it didn't unleash any life energy. Although the corpse was intact, its power was already used up. When Long Chen pulled out the corpse, the spring on the ground stopped emitting blood liquid. It was like the spring was linked to the corpse. It seems that the spirit race's senior is right. Jiang Lei eyed the endless streams of blood stretching beyond the horizon. If every stream represented a corpse, then there could very well be a billion bodies. Long Chen and Jiang Lei pressed on. More streams appeared until they formed an enormous river. The roaring spray of the river sounded like countless fierce beasts roaring Navaloon. Calm the murderous and brutal air grew stronger and stronger. Furthermore, even the sky became the color of blood. It was like the entire world was pressing down, giving people a suffocating feeling. After another day, Long Chen and Jiang Lei encountered two squads of demonic beasts patrolling the area. However, even the strongest amongst them was merely a mid-stage world king. The two of them instantly wiped them out. In the end, Long Chen saw an endless sea. Blood-colored mist rose out of the sea and linked with the sky. This was a blood-colored world. Long Chen had just arrived at the heavenly river Blood Sea when he was spotted. Tens of thousands of demonic beasts roared and attacked them. Chapter 3765, Out of Control World Extermination Flame Lotus Will Blast Through Them. Long Chen's gaze swept out. He didn't see that many experts amongst these people. Even the strongest ones were only half-step divine venerates. Oh, Jiang Lei attacked one of the half-step divine venerates with his lightning sword and destroyed the latter's weapon. He hacked up blood and flew back. It went without saying that after experiencing so much this year, after struggling by the border of death for so long, Jiang Lei's combat experience was incomparable. He directly challenged that expert in his weakest area, striking accurately and ruthlessly. Even against an opponent just as strong as him, he would probably be able to determine victory or defeat in just a few moves. That half-step divine venerate was severely injured in just one attack. He couldn't help being shocked. Suddenly, he waved his hand, and a ray of divine light soared into the sky, exploding like a firework. It illuminated the heavens. A signal. Long Chen was slightly startled. He immediately shot forward and unleashed a follow-up attack on that half-step divine venerate. The Minghong saber pierced through his head. Not good. There are seven divine venerates in the surroundings. After killing him and checking his memories, Long Chen's expression changed. Let's go. There was no time to deal with the riffraff. Long Chen and Jiang Lei shot through them. If a divine venerate were to appear, Long Chen might not be afraid. If he couldn't beat them, he'd run. But against two divine venerates, they might not even have a chance to run. Long Chen randomly chose a direction. As a result, the more you worried about something, the more likely it would happen. Long Chen actually ended up running into three groups, all of them led by divine venerates. Damn human race, have you come to send yourselves to your deaths? The three divine venerates didn't give Long Chen any chance. They directly attacked, seeking to kill the two of them in an instant. Divine Ring, Battle Armor. Long Chen roared and unleashed his full power. He directly charged at one of the divine venerates. At the same time, Huo Linger and Lei Linger went after the other two. Split the heavens three. Long Chen pointed his saber at the heavens. He immediately started off with his strongest attack. When Violet Kai wrapped around his saber, stars danced. Holding his saber with both hands, he slashed down like a heavenly river of stars. Boop! That divine venerate seemed startled by Long Chen's power. The moment that he was locked onto by Long Chen's attack, it was too late to take out his weapon. Long Chen's saber landed directly on his arms, and both of them exploded into blood mist. World Extermination Lightning Radiance. After the divine venerate's arms were destroyed, Jiang Lei smashed a lightning sphere into his body. The demonic beast screamed and was blown back. He smashed into the sea of blood, leaving giant ripples. Just then, another huge explosion unleashed a wave of lightning. Lei Linger was blown apart by her opponent's divine weapon. Clearly, the current Lei Linger could not challenge a divine venerate. As for Huo Linger, she exchanged a direct blow with the true fire sword against her opponent and was also knocked back a few steps. Her opponent staggered. This moment showed off Huo Linger's new power. Let's go. As the blockade was broken, Long Chen grabbed Jiang Lei and charged forward. He chose to go for the weakest one amongst the three to break through. However, just as they were about to break through, a huge net appeared in front of them. The other demonic beasts in this group were using some unknown divine ability. Joining forces, they actually summoned a barrier. Courting death, Long Chen was enraged. If they were blocked by this net, even for just a single breath, they would definitely die. The Ming-Ong saber once more accumulated power and split the heavens slashed down. However, Long Chen was shocked to find that the barrier was flexible and elastic. It was like he had struck a faith barrier. Not only was he blocked, but his attack actually rebounded. The two divine venerates roared and charged at the two of them. Their weapons whistled toward them. Long Chen suddenly shoved Jiang Lei, and using that force, he also retreated. They both dodged the attacks of the divine venerates. It was only thanks to the fact that their fellow demonic beasts were nearby that the two divine venerates weren't unleashing their full power. They were afraid of injuring their own people. Clearly, these people were prepared. Not only were their divine venerates, but even the other experts knew combination techniques. This was all to prevent outsiders from entering the heavenly river Blood Sea. "Boss, I'll block them." "You go." Seeing a divine venerate in front of him and the net barrier behind him, as well as the Blood Sea starting to ripple, showing that the other divine venerate was about to fly out, Jiang Lei shouted and prepared to charge out. "No need," Long Chen shouted. He held his left elbow with his right hand, and his left hand was raised toward the heavens. A snow-white lotus appeared in his hand as sacred chanting filled the air. When the chanting rang out, the Blood Sea roared and the void rumbled. The blood-colored sky was actually torn apart by a mysterious energy. Countless cracks appeared. Flame energy then poured through those cracks, gathering toward Long Chen. In just the blink of an eye, his lotus covered the sky. Long Chen was using the Nirvana scripture, but he himself was shocked. The flame energy of heaven and earth seemed to go crazy this time. It was flowing to him in such an amount that it was out of his control. Most terrifying of all, this was no more than the third volume. Let alone the newly learned fifth volume, he didn't even dare to use the fourth volume. Just as Long Chen was shocked, the flame lotus instantly grew to a size of 10,000 miles. The white lotus was surrounded by black cracks and ripples. It was like the world could not contain its power. Big brother Long Chen, the world extermination flame lotus is about to go out of control. Yuo Linger cried out in shock. She was panicking as well. This huge stream of energy was overflowing. Long Chen didn't dare to tarry. He directly tossed out the rapidly expanding lotus. It was no longer under control. Boom! As soon as it left his hand, it exploded. Long Chen himself was blasted back, almost being killed. If it weren't for his powerful physical body, he'd have definitely died. A white ripple devoured this world. Those demonic beasts didn't even get a chance to scream before they were turned into ice fragments. Long Chen didn't even know how far he was blown back. He felt the world spinning around him, and he hacked up blood. Yuo Linger transformed into a flame dragon and carried Jiang Lei. Even with her protection, Jiang Lei was no better off than Long Chen. Cracks covered his body as if he might shatter at any moment. "Let's go." Long Chen and Jiang Lei didn't bother looking at the aftermath. They directly used their thunder force to run. Boot! The two of them had just left when three wretched figures appeared out of the unstable void. It was precisely those three demonic beast divine venerates. Only the three of them had survived this attack. "Chase!" The three of them roared and shot after the two of them. Chapter 3766 Demonic Beasts Secretly Undergoing Tribulation Split the Heavens 3. Long Chen roared and slashed the Ming-Hong saber. As a result, a supreme expert was blown back, but Long Chen's injuries worsened. After breaking through the blockade of the three divine venerates, Longchen and Jiang Lei ran into several more groups, intercepting them. However, in the final two, there were no divine venerates. In other words, they had reached the core, and only divine lords could enter this place. Despite that, the demonic beast races divine lords came out in an unending tide. The two of them would encounter a new wave every few moments. During normal times, Longchen wouldn't be afraid of them. However, he and Jiang Lei were severely wounded and had yet to have a chance to recover. Longchen pushed aside a supreme heavenly genius and rushed away with Jiang Lei. In the distance, more roars could be heard. There were clearly others fighting the demonic beasts as well. However, Longchen didn't go over. In the 3,000 worlds, the least trustworthy existence was the human race. Finally, they stopped running into more demonic beasts. Only then did Longchen get a breather. He and Jiang Lei took time to recover. As for Lei Linger, she had exhausted a huge amount of her core energy to block the attack of a divine venerate. She also needed to rest. Huo Linger was the same. Having used the world extermination flame lotus at such intensity, she was probably the weariest. It was only thanks to her that they had broken free of the encirclement. How vicious! One layer after another. Once I become an immortal king, I'll slaughter them, cursed Jiang Lei as he recovered. On the outside, there was a layer of experts to probe incoming enemies. The middle had divine venerates standing guard to close any gaps, and at the rear were supreme heavenly geniuses making sure to finish off any fish that got through. Boss, am I useless? My comprehension isn't good enough. My world extermination lightning radiance is a far cry from yours. If I had your skill, we'd have definitely been able to kill those bastards, said Jiang Lei dejectedly. Long Chen had taught him the world extermination lightning radiance, but it still lacked power compared to when Long Chen used it. Jiang Lei was unable to concentrate it even further like Long Chen. Long Chen said, "This has nothing to do with comprehension. Your supreme blood has yet to adapt to you, and your thunder force is also Lei Linger's lightning tribulation energy. These energies didn't originally belong to you. Don't be anxious. During your tribulation, you can absorb its energy, as well as use it to temper your supreme blood and fully merge with it. Then your thunder force will truly be yours." Jiang Lei's expression improved after hearing that. As a dragonblood warrior, he felt immense pressure. Every single person around him was outstanding. If he didn't work hard, he'd be thrown behind. Most importantly, he had a practically monstrous boss. If he didn't go all out, he'd be thrown so far behind that he couldn't even see his back. "Let's go." Long Chen's expression changed suddenly. They couldn't keep recovering. They had just left when dozens of demonic beasts arrived where they had been. One of them sniffed the air. Two people, their blood chi is slightly weak. They should be severely injured. We'll keep chasing. That group rushed off precisely in Long Chen's direction. Boat. A palm-sized formation disc exploded just then, and countless diamond-shaped fragments flew through the air. Those demonic beasts screamed and were turned into sieves. World extermination lightning radiance. Suddenly, lightning exploded amongst them. Those demonic beasts, including a supreme expert, were all slain. Why bother? These weaklings could have just been killed by your sword. No, asked Long Chen. The two of them were forced to repeatedly flee, but were unable to shake off their pursuers. Hence, Long Chen chose to set up a trap with the formation disc that Xia Chen and Yuo Ran had made. This is the only way it's satisfying. I like seeing their corpses blasted out of existence. Cough. Jiang Lei suddenly had a coughing fit. His injuries that had just recovered a bit split open again. The two of them then left this place and found a new location to recover. This time, there were finally no more pursuers. 6 hours later, they had recovered halfway. Like this, they wouldn't have to fear fighting someone in the same realm. As Long Chen recovered, he asked Huo Linger, "How did you lose control of the world extermination flame lotus so quickly this time? What was the problem?" "The Nirvana scripture is different from before. Before this, it was gentle and easy to control. But now, it's explosive. It's like a sheep has become a dragon. Back then, the world's energy poured in crazily, and my own power flowed into the lotus out of my control. Fortunately, you tossed it out in time. Any later and my core energy would have been completely sucked away. Then it would have blown up in your hand," said Huo Linger. Hearing that, Long Chen began to sweat. If the world extermination flame lotus had exploded in his hand, he really would have fallen to his own move. "Big brother Long Chen, I'm sorry. I didn't know the Nirvana scripture would change so much, so I just acted according to the previous times. If I had exercised more control at the start, it wouldn't have gotten out of control so quickly," apologized Huo Linger. "No, it's my fault. I didn't blame you. The main thing is, I also didn't expect that a few changed syllables would cause such a huge change." Long Chen smiled bitterly. He truly didn't blame Huo Linger. They had worked together to unleash the world extermination flame lotus for so many years, and they had always done well. If someone had to be blamed for today's accident, it would have to be him. However, Long Chen was also delighted inside. This was the true Nirvana scripture. If Huo Linger was more cautious and found the right rhythm, the world extermination flame lotus's power would exceed his imagination. Even the third volume of the Nirvana scripture was already so terrifying. If he could use the fifth volume, just how powerful would it be? Long Chen didn't quite dare to believe it. With no one disturbing them, Long Chen calmly recovered. 3 days later, he and Jiang Lei were fully recovered. Suddenly, they heard explosive sounds in the distance. A destructive aura shook their souls. Long Chen and Jiang Lei were both surprised. That aura was. Why would someone be undergoing tribulation at this time? Long Chen and Jiang Lei flew over to that region. They quickly saw thousands of demonic beast disciples undergoing collective tribulation. Navaloon, calm, I understand. After these people undergo tribulation, they'll come for us, said Jiang Lei. You're right. However, they are thinking a bit too simply. Long Chen suddenly smiled sinisterly. A lightning dragon flew out of him and slowly merged into the distant heavenly tribulation. Chapter 3767, The World's Laws. The Heavenly River Blood Sea has yet to start boiling. By undergoing tribulation now, aren't they wasting their chance to change their fates? Jiang Lei couldn't help sighing as he watched them undergo tribulation. The demonic beast race's command system is very simple. It's different from the human race. It's simple, direct, and violent. But it's very effective. The beast race's true experts can decide the fates of the weak. They aren't limited by morality. The weak exist to serve the strong, so the strong order them to do whatever they need. Just like the wolves in a barren wasteland, the wolf king has the highest authority. No other wolves dare to disobey. Who lives and who dies is up to the wolf king, said Long Chen quietly. Animals are animals. They are cold-blooded and merciless, said Jiang Lei coldly. He was especially full of hatred for the demonic beast race. Although the beast race's rules are cruel, they are a reflection of natural law. This is different from the human race. The beast race's connections are dependent on bloodlines, ranking, and social order. But the human race has laws, morality, and feelings to consider. This constraint leads to severe polarization. Kind people are as kind as saints, but evil people are worse than devils. On the other hand, The beast race has to follow their hierarchy, and anyone who disobeys is executed. As a result, the demonic beast race greatly respects these rules, quite different from our situation. The human race's laws usually end up being lax, with people constantly testing the bottom lines of morality and rules. It's unknown just how many people die because of this, but people don't get tired of it. This is human nature. You can't expect the human race to be self-disciplined or hope for them to follow any rules forever. That is because for the human race, the rules are made to be broken, said Long Chen as he eyed those demonic beasts. Boss, I just want to say I'm not questioning you, but I don't quite understand. I feel like you are looking down on the human race's rules. Is being self-disciplined and following the rules not good? Asked Jiang Lei after pondering what Long Chen had just said. Good or bad depends on who sets the rules. What are their goals? Are the rules made for selfish or selfless purposes? Does the person who made the rules also abide by them? Or are the rules only there to restrict other people? Well, let me tell you, up until now, I have yet to encounter someone making the rules. Not the peerless five sovereigns who shook the world, not the ruler of the nation, Big Brother Zaik Yuhong, not the wine god Palace, and not the spirit race. They are all dissatisfied with the world, but I don't know why they never think about changing this world's laws. Perhaps deep inside, they approve of these laws. Or perhaps they don't approve, but can't find better laws to replace them with. Or perhaps, Long Chen suddenly shut his mouth. Long Chen wanted to say that perhaps they didn't have the power to change this world. But they were all people that he revered, so he didn't want to say such a thing. Then, who created the laws of this world? Asked Jian Lei. How could I know? Long Chen sighed. Perhaps no one knew. The sea of bitterness was endless, and everyone was within it, struggling to cross. No one could see the world in its entirety. Rumbling cut off their conversation, as thousands of demonic beasts were undergoing tribulation together. Lightning raged. These demonic beasts were immersed within the lightning. The lightning was constantly strengthening their bodies. Boss, we can charge in and kill them. Maybe I can get some benefits, too, said Jiang Lei as he eyed that lightning a bit greedily. Long Chen said that he had the ability to absorb the power of heavenly tribulation. However, he still didn't know how. He wanted to test it first. Are you a fool? They are on the edge of the core and the outer region. On the other side are divine venerates. If we attack them, we'll be throwing ourselves into a trap. Just conceal your auras and don't be noticed. Lei Linger is already there. Let her get some benefits first, said Long Chen. The two of them hid in the void. They had fully recovered and could control their auras easily. Adding on Zaya Chen's formation discs, as long as they were careful, it was very difficult for others to notice them. Blood-colored mist flowed through the world. Their vision was limited, and their divine sense was suppressed. Long Chen could see the beasts undergoing tribulation, and he sensed a threat beyond them. But he couldn't see their actual figures. When the heavenly tribulation raged, lightning rained down like arrows, which stabbed into the blood sea, causing huge waves. The blood sea was like a boiling pot when struck by lightning. Blood-colored aura flowed out and was absorbed by those experts. I understand. They are undergoing tribulation to stimulate the blood sea, making it boil earlier, said Long Chen suddenly. Why would they do that? Asked Jian Lei. Perhaps too many people have snuck into the heavenly river blood sea, so they have doubt about being able to block outsiders. By having a portion of people first undergo tribulation, they'll have immortal kings in the core preventing outsiders from coming in. At the same time, the heavenly river blood sea will boil earlier. Most likely, the demonic beasts have mostly all arrived, and they don't wish to wait any longer. If they keep waiting, more outsiders will come. That's not beneficial to them, said Long Chen. Is that so? Then, is this group only one portion of the demonic beasts undergoing tribulation in advance? Asked Jiang Lei. Long Chen nodded. Most likely. Those who can break through their defenses to enter the core have to be outstanding figures. These people undergoing tribulation aren't supreme experts, but after they become immortal kings, they will be qualified to fight supreme experts. With a realm advantage and numbers, they'll crush all oppositions. These demonic beasts might not be supreme experts, but all of them had astonishing blood chi. Once they became immortal kings, their combat power would grow explosively. If they also condensed heavenly Tao crowns, they might have power rivaling supreme divine lords. A group of strong immortal kings was something that even supreme geniuses would have to avoid. The demonic beast race had sacrificed the opportunities of a portion of their disciples to prevent outsiders from benefiting. It was truly ruthless. At the same time, the Blood Sea's temperature was starting to rise. Bubbles were rising from the depths, and the blood chi fluctuations in the air grew increasingly strong. All kinds of phenomena were occurring, gradually validating Long Chen's speculation. Suddenly, ancient beasts came flying out of the tribulation clouds, attacking the demonic beasts. Upon seeing this, Long Chen slowly smiled. A demonic beast was directly crushed to bits by the claw of a lightning beast, and his companions screamed in shock. Chapter 3768, Chosen by the Heavens. Careful, this is the final wave of the heavenly tribulation. Hold on. One of the demonic beasts shouted a reminder, only for another lightning beast to tear him to pieces. Thousands of experts undergoing tribulation together would naturally cause its power to rise, and the extent of the increase was not limited to just a dozen times. For this many experts to undergo tribulation together, there was naturally a high chance of them being wiped out. However, while their tribulation looked mighty, it wasn't particularly powerful. This was only the third wave. Anyway, this was just a normal tribulation. If you compared this with the tempo of Long Chen's heavenly tribulation, it was nothing more than a drizzle. An ordinary person's tribulation usually had three waves, each wave stronger than the last. If they could pass through all three, they would have succeeded. However, this third wave was clearly more terrifying than they had imagined. Those lightning beasts descended from the nine heavens with murderous auras, crazily attacking them. As the lightning beasts attacked, the demonic beasts collapsed. Amongst those terrifying lightning beasts, one in particular was very terrifying. It was in the shape of a lightning dragon, and not a single person was capable of blocking its attack. This lightning dragon was Leylinger. She finally found a chance to kill. In just a few breaths, thousands of experts were reduced to a few dozen. This heavenly tribulation was too terrifying. They all despaired. Even the divine venerates in the distance sighed as they watched this. They didn't dare to try interfering in this tribulation or say anything, afraid of the karma from the heavenly tribulation locking onto them. However, what shocked people was that the lightning dragon suddenly stopped massacring the demonic beasts. It actually changed sides, devouring the other lightning beasts. Seeing this scene, the demonic beast experts were stunned. Only Long Chen knew that Leylinger's goal was to devour as many of the lightning beasts as possible. She had killed the demonic beast experts first, so they wouldn't absorb too much of the tribulation's power. However, she also couldn't kill them all because once they were all dead, the tribulation would end. She only left a few stragglers. As Leylinger devoured the lightning beasts, those stragglers that were in despair were revitalized. They fought all out, blocking the lightning beasts with all their power. Although they didn't know what was going on, this slight chance was worth fighting for. This third wave contained the true essence of the heavenly tribulation, and these lightning beasts were all immortal king realm existences, the perfect nourishment for Lay Linger. As she had received a full power attack from a divine venerate before this, which caused her body to crumble, a great deal of her core energy was lost. Facing this third wave, she had not just replenished her core energy, but her power was also crazily rising. However, even with Lay Linger devouring the lightning beasts, there were so many of them that the remaining 20, some experts were quickly reduced to 9. That glimmer of hope that they felt faded. "Hold on!" another expert shouted, only to be torn apart by a lightning beast. All of a sudden, Lay Linger saw that those people were surrounded by lightning beasts. She panicked when she knew that they were going to be killed. Hence, she barged in. With a rake of her claw, those lightning beasts exploded. In the end, one survivor of the demonic beasts remained. Lay Linger protected him with her body as he devoured the other lightning beasts. An hour later, the lightning beasts were all devoured, and the tribulation clouds faded. All of a sudden, that person's aura soared explosively. I advanced to the Immortal King realm. The surviving demonic beast looked at his surroundings in disbelief. He felt like he was dreaming. Lay Linger released him and looked at him calmly. The distant demonic beasts, including the divine venerates, didn't dare to believe their eyes. They had no idea what was going on. Could he be the legendary chosen of the heavens? Did he have a heavenly lightning divine beast to protect him? Wondered a divine venerate. "Quick, the heavenly tribulation is gone. Make yourself its master," shouted another divine venerate. That person only reacted now and shouted, "I am your master. Submit to me." The lightning dragon's tail instantly shot up in response. The demonic beast people were delighted, but that delight quickly vanished. That was because they saw the tail viciously smashing toward the sole survivor. It was like a hammer striking a melon. Blood mist filled the air as that person was killed. The lightning dragon then spat on the remains of that person, and its claw gestured disdainfully. Just like that, it vanished into the void, leaving behind a group of dumbfounded demonic beasts that were standing there like wooden statues. They didn't know what to say. Long Chen and Jiang Lei couldn't help laughing when they saw what Lay Linger did and the resulting dumbfounded expressions of the demonic beasts. Lay Linger ate her fill and then actually looked at the demonic beasts disdainfully before leaving. Chosen of the heavens? Becoming her master. What a joke. However, their laughter quickly faded away. That was because they saw the demonic beasts in the distance glaring at them with murderous gazes. "They can see us?" Long Chen was startled. "It seems so." Jian Lei fell silent as well. Long Chen looked around and jumped. At some point, the surrounding blood-colored mist had vanished and the sky was clear. There were no clouds. He suddenly realized that he could see countless experts just like them staring blankly at the surroundings. Long Chen's formation disk was a mirror reflection formation disk. It reflected the mist around them so that it was as if they were merged into it. As long as they didn't reveal their auras, they wouldn't be seen. However, now that the mist was gone, only they appeared to have blood-colored mist around them. Anyone who wasn't blind could clearly see them. "Damn human race, you did this," roared a divine venerate. "Even if we did, so what? What are you going to do?" "Come and bite me," dared Long Chen. With the mist scattered, Long Chen could now see a milky white ripple on the edge of the heavenly river Blood Sea. This ripple was what separated the core from the outside. Only divine lords could cross through here, so Long Chen wasn't afraid of them. "Foolish human race, you'll never understand just how terrifying the great demonic beast race is. All that awaits you is despair and death. The divine venerate snorted. He looked at them like they were already dead. Just then, countless arsed sword and demonic beasts crashed down on Long Chen from every direction. There were countless supreme auras amongst them. The foolish one is you. I will use my actions to teach you what regret is. Long Chen's blood instantly ignited when he saw these opponents. He turned and faced the oncoming demonic beasts. Chapter 3769. Boiling blood. See, this place is the demonic beast race's sacred land. It's not somewhere your inferior human race can step into. Countless demonic beasts charged over at Long Chen and Zhang Lei. They were blazing with killing intent. The demonic beast race's sacred land. What a joke. A billion of your ancestors were killed here. This is a graveyard. You dare to call it a sacred land? Long Chen laughed mockingly. Nonsense. A demonic beast supreme expert roared furiously. His wings flapped, and he suddenly appeared in front of Long Chen, smashing his rod at Long Chen's head. He hated Long Chen, so he immediately launched a full power attack. In return, the Minghong saber came out of its sheath. Long Chen blocked, and his saber actually unleashed a soft energy upon clashing with the rod. After quivering three times, the majority of the energy in the rod dissipated. After that, with a shove of the saber, that person was knocked toward Jiang Lei. Jiang Lei was prepared, and his lightning sword instantly cut off his head. Don't fight them directly. Save your energy in case we encounter any peak experts, reminded Long Chen. Lightning wings then spread on his back, and he charged toward the weakest part of their blockade. Long Chen and Zhang Lei didn't let themselves be bogged down by the small fries. They only killed the supreme geniuses. On the other hand, the demonic beasts tried to surround them, but their speed was inferior. Ultimately, they were unable to catch Long Chen and Zhang Lei. They cursed and howled as they chased. That drew the attention of even more demonic beasts. Hence, more and more of them began chasing Long Chen. Originally, it was tens of thousands of people, but that quickly became hundreds of thousands. After an instant's stick's worth of time, it was millions. These millions of experts were in a life-and-death pursuit on top of the heavenly river Blood Sea. Just as they saw that they were about to surround Long Chen suddenly swung his saber, tearing open their enclosure and easily escaping once more. The demonic beasts cursed furiously. The heavenly river Blood Sea was enormous, but Long Chen was only moving within a small region of it. It was because he didn't want to draw the attention of more peak experts. Otherwise, just like rolling a snowball, this army would grow bigger and bigger until they would eventually exhaust him. However, despite moving in a small region, the army chasing him continued to grow. More supreme experts arrived, and some of them were shockingly talented. Their divine abilities applied immense pressure on Long Chen and Zhang Lei, so their options grew more and more limited. Just like that, avoiding the encirclement got increasingly difficult. Just as Long Chen was fighting the demonic beasts, he also heard intense rumbling in the distance. Clearly, the demonic beasts were also fighting others. It was unknown what race those people were from. Big brother Long Chen, let's work together again. We'll unleash the world extermination flame lotus. Huolinger transformed into a tiny flame dragon sitting on Long Chen's shoulder. She spoke into his ear. No, you still haven't recovered, and we might lose control over it again. Even if we don't and manage to kill them all, it means nothing. The world extermination flame lotus uses up a huge amount of my spiritual strength and mental energy. With my tribulation coming soon, I have to be fully focused on it. There can be no mistakes, said Long Chen. Big brother Long Chen, let me release the world extermination lightning radiance then. Leilinger also transformed into a tiny lightning dragon on Long Chen's other shoulder. Long Chen didn't know whether to laugh or cry. These two really were growing more warlike. You can't attack either. The heavenly tribulation will start soon. Although you can replenish your energy through it, things are too chaotic here. There are too many experts, and no one knows what will happen. Furthermore, the terrain here is special, which makes the laws of the heavenly Taos erratic. Just rest for now. Don't worry, you'll have a chance to show off soon, said Long Chen. Hearing that, Lei Linger and Huo Linger stopped bothering him, but they refused to retreat. They just stayed on his shoulders and fought alongside him. Long Chen and Jiang Lei were constantly chased and surrounded by the demonic beasts. They charged through any holes they could find, conveniently killing a few on the way. On the outside, the divine venerates grew anxious. They began to shout, directing the army. However, although these demonic beasts were conscious of being in a group and often fought in group battles, their fighting style was only to fight for themselves. Even in groups, they didn't cooperate beyond the absolute basics. They couldn't fight in an orderly formation like the human race. Thus, while this army of millions looked very frightening, they were a plate of loose sand. As long as Long Chen didn't find them directly, they were unable to deal a fatal blow to him. The left, up ahead, in front of you. I said in front of you. You idiots, are you all idiots? He's running in that direction again. Stop him, shouted a divine venerate, cursing as he directed the troops. This divine venerate was clearly the idiot. Long Chen was so fast and agile, moving in every direction. These people had long since grown dizzy chasing him. Left. That was from his own viewpoint. The experts chasing him were facing every single direction. Left. It would be better if he didn't say anything. Now that he was trying to give directions, these people were like headless flies, crashing into each other chaotically. Shut your fucking mouth, shouted a supreme expert finally. These people came from the nine heavens and ten lands. Although they were both demonic beasts, they didn't know each other. Moreover, these heavenly geniuses were all arrogant. It was clearly a problem with the person trying to direct them, yet he cursed them as idiots. These heavenly geniuses had long since grown enraged by him. The divine venerate's face was dark with fury. If it weren't for the fact that he didn't dare to cross the barrier, he'd definitely beat up that fellow. Non-supreme experts should retreat. We don't need you here. Scram, shouted a demonic beast covered in golden scales. Following that roar, the ordinary demonic beasts fell back. Their speed was inferior, and their power wasn't great enough. They were only causing disorder here. It would be better for them to retreat. Now that only a few hundred powerful supreme experts were chasing them, Long Chen and Jiang Lei instantly felt the pressure increase. Boss, it's no good. We can only start fighting them directly. Jiang Lei cursed as he panted. Without those people as a hindrance, these supreme experts were finally able to display their power. In an instant, there was nowhere for Long Chen to run. Long Chen was about to speak when the heavenly river blood sea began to boil. At the same time, the heavens roared and grand Tao runes rained down. The heavenly river blood sea is boiling. The time to undergo tribulation has come. Damn human race, let's see how your weak bodies are turned to dust in front of heavenly tribulation. The demonic beasts cried out excitedly as their auras erupted, their shackles shattering. Tribulation clouds gathered in the sky. At that moment, Long Chen finally sighed with relief. Looking at the delighted expressions of the demonic beasts around him, he smiled. Chapter 3770. Underworld Eye Giant Jiang Lei was also delighted. But the most delighted one was Lei Linger. She coiled around Long Chen's body excitedly as a lightning dragon. The surrounding supreme heavenly geniuses unleashed their auras, breaking through to the next realm. Lightning rumbled. At the same time, Blood Kai shot out of the heavenly river blood sea, pouring toward those demonic beasts. This is our demonic beast race's sacred land. By borrowing the power of the heavenly tribulation to temper our bodies, we can absorb the bloodline power of our ancestors better, merging with their runes and awakening their divine abilities. As for your inferior human race, you think you can steal our treasures? Keep dreaming, shouted a supreme expert, blood-colored chains wrapping around his body. His blood Kai was climbing frantically. Just as he said, the billion beast venerates within the heavenly river blood sea were dead, their bodies decayed. But their soul essence remained, and their essence blood was gathered here. Moreover, their soul essence actually absorbed the energy of heaven and earth to preserve their essence blood and the runes within it, forming the heavenly river blood sea for future descendants. A billion beast venerates, encapsulating countless races. Thus, this place became the sacred land of the demonic beasts. Undergoing tribulation here would allow them to receive the blessing of their ancestors. They could then absorb their ancestors' bloodline power, making it easier for them to awaken their divine abilities and activate a heavenly Tao crown. Thus, this place was always guarded by the demonic beast race. Other races were not allowed in. Despite that, outsiders constantly tried to enter. Although they couldn't awaken such divine abilities or receive a blessing, what they wanted was the power of the essence blood here. After all, this power was not limited to one race. It could greatly improve a person's essence blood in terms of both purity and power. Even so, this kind of power was normally impossible to absorb, let alone for other races. Even the demonic beast races were incapable of it. It was only during the baptism of heavenly tribulation that the impurities within the blood sea could be driven out. This kind of opportunity was something that even outsider races could absorb. Thus, despite this being viewed as a forbidden land of the demonic beast race, countless outsider experts continued to try to break in. This place still had a fatal attraction that brought people to their deaths. At this moment, spears of lightning fell from the sky. They were absolutely terrifying, their power on par with the third wave of tribulation from the previous group of demonic beasts. One lightning spear directly landed on Long Chen's head, but he didn't even glance at it. It simply shattered on contact, as this level of lightning was unable to harm him. Boss, we should also undergo tribulation. Let them know what a true heavenly tribulation is, urged Jiang Lei. He knew that Long Chen's heavenly tribulations were always the most terrifying. Previously, Jiang Lei had been afraid of his heavenly tribulations. But now that he was a lightning attribute supreme expert, he was looking forward to it. Hundreds of supreme experts surrounded them, but they didn't attack. They simply allowed the heavenly tribulation to descend, so this place would become a terrifying region of heavenly lightning. It seemed that they wished to enjoy the sight of Long Chen dying to heavenly tribulation. Countless demonic beasts were starting their tribulations outside of this region as well. The entire heavenly river blood sea was boiling. With its help, there was little chance of dying to heavenly tribulation. That was why they were so brazen as to undergo collective tribulation. However, those people did distance themselves from these supreme heavenly geniuses. After all, there was a huge difference in their tribulations. If they were affected by the lightning from these supreme heavenly geniuses, they might be instantly wiped out. Don't be anxious. Now that the heavenly tribulation has descended, there's nothing for us to fear. Let's go take a look somewhere else. Long Chen suddenly shot into motion. He charged at those supreme heavenly geniuses undergoing tribulation. Don't kill him. That's letting him off too easily. We'll make him die bit by bit in endless despair, shouted one of the demonic beasts. Long Chen easily charged through this enclosure, and these demonic beasts followed him, not letting him leave the range of their heavenly tribulation. Get out of the way. Long Chen was now out, with the supreme experts chasing him. However, they quickly saw him rushing toward those ordinary demonic beasts. The latter instantly turned green and fled. However, within this lighting-filled area, their speed was clearly impacted. They weren't even as fast as before. As a result, the weaker ones were instantly covered by the heavenly tribulations of the supreme experts. Quite a few of them had lightning spears blast through their bodies. Just like that, an army of millions was instantly sliced through in the middle. In truth, Long Chen wasn't moving that quickly because he wasn't planning on leaving the scope of these supreme experts' heavenly tribulation. After all, in order to prepare for the true heavenly tribulation, a warm-up was necessary. Whether it was Lei Linger or Jiang Lei absorbing this lightning would strengthen them. Long Chen led hundreds of heavenly geniuses with an enormous heavenly tribulation above them. Just like that, he charged into the center of the heavenly river Blood Sea. He quickly saw more demonic beasts. That group was fighting an enormous giant with a hammer. This giant was actually chasing down and killing the demonic beasts. With a single swing of the hammer, countless demonic beasts were sent flying. There were actually several supreme geniuses amongst them. Long Chen and Jiang Lei both cried out in shock. That giant's back was very similar to Wilda's. However, when the giant turned around, they were disappointed. This giant had tusks and a single eye. It was quite an ominous appearance. He wasn't Wilda. The one-eyed giant roared and swung his hammer again. At this moment, black runes lit up on it, and a violent aura erupted. When a black Kai wave unfurled, the demonic beasts fighting the giant were blasted apart. Only supreme experts were able to resist, but they were also sent flying. Absolutely terrifying. What is this life form? Jiang Lei jumped in shock. He had never seen such an existence before. Even dozens of supreme heavenly geniuses were utterly defeated. He should be from the Netherworld's Underworld Eye Giant race. It's a famous existence within the Underworld race. Also, his physical body isn't even his strongest point. The most terrifying part is his eye, said Long Chen gravely. Long Chen had seen some records in the Netherworld of an existence that was very similar to this giant. He was very similar to the Underworld Eye Giant. Under the Netherworld's Underworld and Nether Race distinction, this person belonged to the Underworld race, while Wu Tian was from the Nether Race. Also, the Underworld race viewed Long Chen as a mortal enemy, so this Underworld Eye Giant was definitely one of his strong opponents. Long Chen. At this moment, the giant sensed Long Chen staring at him. He immediately roared furiously and charged toward Long Chen. Chapter 3771. Kun Tu, the Underworld Eye Giant, actually recognized Long Chen and charged toward him. However, as his body was so huge, he was forced to move through a greater amount of lightning, causing resistance. Hence, his speed wasn't very fast. It was due to this that he ended up entangled by those demonic beasts. His power was terrifying, but he was unable to launch a killing blow on those supreme heavenly geniuses. It seems that Big Brother Wu Tian's influence in the Netherworld is growing. Long Chen smiled slightly. Long Chen was full of respect when it came to Wu Tian. He was a good friend whose word was solid, and he repaid gratitude and enmity. But rarest of all, both of them possessed a heaven-defying will to topple this entire world. Ignoring the Underworld Eye Giant, Long Chen continued leading an army of demonic beasts forward. The Underworld Eye Giant's speed was its fatal weakness. It was instantly thrown behind as Long Chen continued deeper. Long Chen saw more and more battlefields. He also found powerful experts of other races fighting the demonic beasts. These experts were all terrifying, not at all weaker compared to the underworld eye giant he had just seen. Even against dozens of the demonic beast race's supreme experts, they were not defeated. Why are there no human experts? There's also not a single dragonblood warrior. After going through hundreds of battlefields, they didn't spot a single person from the human race, let alone the brothers that they had long since anticipated seeing. Long Chen also found it curious. With there being so many dragonblood warriors, it was impossible that not a single one would come here. All the dragonblood warriors focused on tempering their blood kai. Hence, no matter how dangerous the heavenly river blood sea was, surely some of them would come. Even Boss Gu Yang isn't here. He couldn't have failed to come, could he? Wondered Jiang Lei. Let's keep looking. Long Chen continued roaming this land. In truth, the experts chasing him had long since started to grow impatient. They had originally been anticipating to see Long Chen and Jiang Lei struggle bitterly within their heavenly tribulation. After all, the human race's physical bodies were weak compared to theirs. However, when this heavenly tribulation landed on Long Chen's body, it was like he didn't even sense it. So, they were starting to get a bad feeling. They chased after them, but Long Chen didn't even give them a chance to surround him. He just roved through the battlefields. They had to chase Long Chen while resisting the heavenly tribulation and absorbing the lightning. It was very difficult, but they couldn't give up either. They could only curse and shout at him as they chased. "There's a human expert." Suddenly, Jiang Lei cried out excitedly. However, once they got close, they were once more disappointed. This person might be human, but he was from the Dragon Blood Legion. He was a powerful beast cultivator with shocking blood kai. Although he was a human, his blood kai was even more terrifying than a demonic beast. Furthermore, it was very mixed. It seemed that he had absorbed the essence blood of countless demonic beasts. Also, the demonic beasts attacking him were so crazed as though they had encountered the one who had killed their fathers. However, this beast cultivator easily blocked their assault with a wave of his hand. There was no sign of him being defeated. This person is very powerful. He's still holding back. Long Chen's expression changed slightly. His intuition told him that this person was very dangerous. This person also sensed Long Chen. Looking through space, he looked at Long Chen guardedly. His eyes were very strange. They were like a falcon's eyes, yet also like a crocodile's eyes. His pupils were constantly changing. Although he was human, Long Chen had no desire to greet him. Hence, Long Chen continued moving through the heavenly river Blood Sea, hoping to find people that he knew. Seeing Long Chen leave, that person's expression relaxed slightly. He was clearly very wary of Long Chen. Long Chen continued searching when dozens of supreme experts appeared in front of him and blocked his way. These people had blood on their bodies. It seemed that they had just slain some experts. Afraid of being blocked by them and once more being surrounded, Long Chen took a sharp turn. He himself no longer knew where he was. There were increasingly many demonic beasts in the surroundings. Furthermore, their auras were also growing more powerful. "Boss, do you think that we've entered their secret land?" Jiang Lei sensed their powerful auras. Although they were supreme experts just like the others, the pressure they gave off was far greater. The demonic beasts here were far more powerful. Probably. The heavenly river Blood Sea is enormous, so it's definitely hiding some secret. I want to find it. For more demonic beasts to appear here, there had to be something up. Furthermore, the demonic beasts actually weren't undergoing tribulation. It seemed that they were waiting for something. Now that Long Chen had arrived here, The commerce in this region was shattered. Countless experts held and attacked him. "Boss, the blood sea here hasn't started boiling," observed Jiang Lei. "It seems that this must be the core of the Heavenly River Blood Sea. They won't let outsiders get here." Long Chen also noticed this oddity. It seemed that some terrifying energy was hidden deep within this region. "Long Chen, there was a path to heaven, but you didn't walk it. There was no door to hell, but you still dove through it. Did you intentionally come to get killed by me?" Suddenly, an icy voice came from the depths of the Heavenly River Blood Sea. "The Heavenly Daos," cried out as soon as this voice appeared. Following that, the experts chasing Long Chen stopped and created a path. At the end of the path was an expert wrapped in lightning runes. Pun 2. Long Chen couldn't help but smile. He hadn't expected Kantu to be viewed so highly by the demonic beast race. It seemed that these supreme demonic beasts listened to his orders. Kantu slowly walked over. Every step caused blood-colored cracks to appear beneath his feet and thunderous booms to shake the world. Even the sound of tribulations in the distance was covered up by this sound. Also, his blood Kai was so powerful that it shook the sun, moon, and stars. "You want to kill me? With your power? That sounds like a fantasy." Long Chen shook his head at Kantu, stopping in the air. Kantu was a true Kunpeng. Having experienced countless tribulations, he was an expert that had walked out of true hardships and trials. Although a true Kunpeng possessed the primordial Kunpeng bloodline, one might not appear even once in millions of years. Because of the reasons above, all the demonic beasts here were reverent of Kantu. They were like subjects looking at their emperor. They didn't even dare to form a will to resist him. The Kunpeng bloodline had a terrifying bloodline suppression effect on countless demonic beasts. It was similar to the true dragon race's sacred dragon might. As for Kantu, as a first-generation Kunpeng, his bloodline pressure was exceptionally strong. Even these supreme experts respected him as their king. "Ha ha ha ha, interesting. Let alone with your mixed dragon blood, even if you had pure ancestral dragon essence blood, you wouldn't be qualified to act arrogant in front of me. The true dragon race is nothing more than prey for my Kunpeng race, let alone a human who only absorbed dragon blood," said Kantu arrogantly, like an absolute king. "Pray, then how come I've heard that the Kunpeng race once submitted and was subservient to the dragon race? Isn't that the only reason your race wasn't wiped out? Do you dare to swear on your soul that such a thing never happened?" asked Long Chen lightly. Courting death, Kantu was enraged and extended his hand. His sharp claws broke through the void, reaching toward Long Chen. Chapter 3772 Heaven-Defying Wills Clash Bang. Long Chen unleashed a simple punch against Kantu's claws. Neither of them used divine abilities. Just relying on the power of their physical bodies, they made a raging Kai wave erupt. But the next moment, sharp pain came from Long Chen's fist. Five bloody marks were left on it by Kantu's claws. "Buzz!" Jiang Lei was shocked. Just how powerful was Long Chen's physical body? Jiang Lei had personally witnessed his power, but Long Chen was actually injured by Kantu. "You think you can block me with just your physical body?" A mantis stopping a cart, an ant shaking a tree, absolutely laughable. Kantu retrieved his claws, which were stained by golden blood. It was Long Chen's true dragon essence blood. Kantu then stuck out his tongue and lightly licked his claws. As he did so, his eyes narrowed slightly, and a cold smile appeared on his face. "The dragon race's flesh and blood really is delicious. It's just a shame that it's mixed with the flavor of the human race. You've ruined its original flavor. Long Chen, you really deserve death." The current Kantu was like a bloodthirsty devil. His killing intent seemed to have been stimulated by the dragon blood. Now, his blood Kai rumbled, and a terrifying pressure was unleashed, almost suffocating the experts in the surroundings. Even supreme experts felt minuscule in front of that aura. Long Chen looked at the broken scales on his hand. His skin had been broken in 5 places, and golden blood dripped out of those wounds. At this moment, the primal chaos space's energy flowed in, but only caused those injuries to slowly close. There was no instantaneous recovery. Amazing. An attack containing the will of the Kunpeng that can transcend the heavenly Taos. I didn't expect you to have such a power. Long Chen's gaze sharpened. His battle intent continued to climb. It was Long Chen's first time encountering such a thing. The Kunpeng race was truly worthy of being a heaven-defying existence. However, this injury didn't make Long Chen afraid and instead only stimulated his will to fight even more. I also have this power. How interesting. Are you saying that you also possess this kind of power? Sneered Kuntu. Long Chen lightly clenched his hand. The injury finally healed. Of course. I also possess this power. Ah! Kuntu raised his head and laughed as if he had just heard the world's funniest joke. You have this power as well. The inferior human race also possesses the power to defy the heavens. Your dragon blood isn't even the ancestral dragon blood, and yet you speak of heaven-defying power. Are you trying to make me laugh to death? Long Chen shook his head. My heaven-defying power doesn't stem from true dragon essence blood. It stems from myself. Suddenly, Long Chen unsheathed the Ming-Ong saber, and a domineering and wild will erupted. He then slashed his saber. Boom! When Long Chen's saber clashed with Kuntu's sharp claws, 2 formless yet substantial wills clashed. A pillar of light then soared into the heavens, breaking through the sky, shaking the stars high above. At that moment, the wind and clouds changed color. The world almost shattered as all kinds of strange phenomena instantly descended. As a result, countless Grand Tao runes crashed as if the end of the world had come. The eruption of both of their wills caused the surrounding experts to flee in terror. Their souls quaked and their bodies quivered. This was a fear that came from the depths of their soul. The heavenly Taos. Everyone had to be respectful of them, and they couldn't even think of defying them. But those who did defy the heavens were above the heavenly Taos. Such existences possessed absolutely terrifying mental energy. Although this kind of energy was unable to cause direct damage, it could completely obliterate a person's confidence, making them too terrified to even think about fighting. At this moment, the sky shook and the 10,000 Taos roared. Kuntu and Long Chen looked at each other, both of their gazes almost exploding with fire. As both of them possessed the power to defy the heavens, they tried to suppress the other side's will. The human race also has a heaven-defying will. Stop joking around. Your human race is the lowest of all races. You struggled at the bottom and were enslaved for countless years. The slave character has long since been imprinted into the depths of your soul. You are only fit to be lowly slaves, shouted Kuntu, his battle intent climbing. The cycle turns. The heavenly Taos remain in motion. In this world, no one remains at the bottom forever. In the same vein, no one remains at the top forever. Do you think that your Kunpeng race can rely on an undefeatable legend to forever shine? If you really were so great, you wouldn't beg for mercy from the dragon race just to survive, sneered Long Chen. Whenever Long Chen mentioned the Kunpeng race submitting to the dragon race, Kuntu was enraged. His eyes turned scarlet, and endless killing intent erupted from within him. Suddenly, the space behind Kuntu exploded and a giant illusory figure spread. It was enormous, so big that it covered the entire sky and more. People couldn't even see its whole body. At the same time, a terrifying, desolate cry radiated from it. All the experts present grunted as a violent power struck them and sent them flying. They'd barely managed to stabilize themselves many miles away. At this great distance, they could finally see that the illusory figure was a giant fish-shaped life form. Its aura caused their souls to shake, and its black eyes in particular were so imposing that no one dared to look at them directly. It was like just a look would suck in their souls. It's the ancestral Kun. In the immortal world, people had seen the Pang, but they had never seen the Kun. That was because the Kun was a life form of the mortal world. It was not possible to see them in the immortal world. Only when they ascended from the mortal world would the Kun appear in the form of the Pang. Thus, the immortal world had countless Pang races, but no one had ever seen the Kun, let alone the ancestral Kun that walked through tribulation after tribulation, trial after trial. At this moment, the ancestral Kun manifestation distorted this entire world. It was like this world could not contain it. The heavenly river Blood Sea even started subsiding, and huge waves exploded out of it. At the same time, it seemed that something within the Blood Sea began to move. What a terrifying aura! Long Chen was also shocked by this manifestation. It was his first time feeling such a terrifying aura, as even divine venerates didn't possess such auras. When Kun Tu unleashed his manifestation, Long Chen's divine ring automatically appeared along with his six-star battle armor. Long Chen didn't dare to be careless against Kun Tu. He had to unleash his full power as well. Inferior human race, do you think that the great Kun Peng race is something that you can speak of? Die, roared Kun Tu. Long Chen had brought up the Kun Peng's submission to the dragon race twice now. That was a part of the history that the Kun Peng race refused to admit to. Kun Tu then attacked with his claws once more. At the same time as he moved, the ancestral Kun in his manifestation suddenly quivered. Water-like ripples then flowed into Kun Tu's arm. As a result, the void shattered and a monstrous fish mark appeared on Kun Tu's claws. That was the image of the ancestral Kun. Countless stars shook in the sky, with one star after another lighting up. Once they lit up, stars also lit up on Long Chen's Minghong saber. Drawing stars into the body split the heavens three. Long Chen slashed his saber with all his power, wielding it with both hands. A violet starry river then slashed down on Kun Tu's claw. Chapter 3773, Fight of Tribulation Clouds Boom. Two destructive energies crashed, unleashing a huge explosion that tore through the heavenly river Blood Sea. As a result, countless bones were blown into the air from the depths of the sea. Those bones were the size of mountains, and together they had filled the bottom of the sea. However, the clash between Long Chen and Kun Tu caused those bones to once more see the sun. The moment they were exposed, the runes on them lit up. Powerful auras erupted from them as if those bones were alive. Boom! The blasted seawater once more fell, and angry waves raged. After that, the seawater covered the bones once again. Long Chen and Kun Tu both grunted and fell back. Long Chen coughed up blood, and the stars above his head actually vanished. Kun Tu was in a similar situation. After coughing up blood, his ancestral Kun manifestation vanished. He was unable to summon it again temporarily, which shocked him tremendously. As for Long Chen, he was also shocked. The stars in the nine heavens had vanished from his senses. He had lost the mental connection with them. That made him unable to draw in their astral power. That last blow wasn't his absolute strongest blow. After all, merging all three forms of split the heavens into one was his true killer blow. He had saved his power just to unleash this move, but now he was unable to use it. However, seeing that Kun Tu's ancestral Kun manifestation had also vanished, along with his shocked expression, Longchen felt much better. Kun Tu's manifestation was gone, but Longchen's divine ring was still present with the 6-star battle armor still active. Even if he couldn't draw in more astral energy, he was still in a powerful state. Longchen then shot after Kun Tu just like that. He wanted to properly experience the power of a Kun Peng. As for Kun Tu, now that his ancestral Kun manifestation was gone, a pair of giant wings suddenly appeared on his back. His aura might not be as vast as before, but it was still enough to shock countless life forms. He also charged at Longchen. Just as the two of them were about to clash again, the Heavenly River Blood Sea exploded. An enormous pillar of light soared out of the sea. Before Longchen and Kun Tu clashed, they were struck by that divine light. As a result, both of them were blown into the sky like shooting stars. When people saw their figures afterward, they were all shocked. Both of them were now terribly bloody and deformed. Longchen's innards and bones were exposed. As for Kun Tu, his body was clearly stronger than Longchen's. Although he was covered in blood, it was only on the surface. Everyone stared in horror at that pillar of light. They had no idea what had happened. Even Longchen and Kun Tu were almost killed by that light. If it had happened to anyone else, they would have doubtlessly died. Everyone, including Longchen and Kun Tu, was stunned. This pillar of light came out of nowhere. It was bizarre. The divine light struck the dome of the heavens. A hole then appeared in the sky and spread. There's blood Kai energy, spiritual energy, mental energy. The treasures of our ancestors have been activated. The Heavenly River Blood Sea's energy is fully ignited. We are the final generation that will benefit from it. A supreme expert cried out emotionally. This pillar of light contained multitudes of energy. It was like an erupting volcano, covering the entire Heavenly River Blood Sea with its power. Now, the Heavenly River Blood Sea was fully boiling, and blood Kai filled the air. It was like just taking a breath could cause a person's physical body to grow stronger. Longchen was stunned. He hadn't expected his fight with Kun Tu to detonate all the energy within the bones at the bottom of the river. After this eruption, there would no longer be a Heavenly River Blood Sea in the 3,000 worlds. What are you waiting for? Undergo tribulation. When someone shouted, countless auras broke through their limits, drawing down heavenly tribulation. They began breaking through to the Immortal King realm. Little human, you think you're qualified to fight me? You'll simply be destroyed by my Kun Peng tribulation, roared Kun Tu. After exchanging 2 blows with Longchen, although it looked as if Kun Tu had the advantage as a Kun Peng that had slaughtered his way out of the mortal world and into the immortal world, he was unwilling to accept such a result. That was because in all his life, he had never encountered anyone in the same realm who was a match for him. As for Longchen, he was nothing more than a human. Simply, by virtue of possessing impure dragon blood, he was able to force Kun Tu to this extent. Thinking of this, Kun Tu was enraged. When Kun Tu broke through his shackles, an enormous tribulation cloud appeared above his head. As it appeared, the tribulation clouds of the others were all devoured. Your heavenly tribulation? Good, let me see whose heavenly tribulation is stronger, Longchen shouted. His silent cultivation base then charged through its seal like a volcano that had been suppressed for millions of years. As a result, a tribulation cloud appeared above Longchen's head as well, and its range was even greater than Kun Tu's. When it appeared, a destructive aura filled the world. The other people's tribulation clouds quivered, not daring to keep up their work. Instead, they actually moved toward Longchen's tribulation clouds like troops seeing the emperor. They could only unconditionally submit. How can this be? The experts, borrowing the power of the lightning to absorb the blood sea's energy, were all dumbfounded. The moment Long Chen's tribulation appeared, their tribulation clouds were crushed. Kun Tu's expression sank. He had not expected Long Chen's tribulation cloud to be even bigger than his. How could someone have a more terrifying heavenly tribulation than him? Both of their tribulation clouds limitlessly grew, devouring other people's tribulation clouds. Those experts were left dumbfounded. They stared in disbelief at the sky. Two tribulation clouds spread further and further, practically covering the entire heavenly river Blood Sea. Of course, all the experts undergoing tribulation had their tribulation clouds devoured by the two of them. They no longer saw any lightning in the air. Instead, a deathly silence hung. As for the demonic beasts outside, they were dumbfounded by what they were seeing. They had never seen or even heard of such a huge tribulation before. The people undergoing tribulation had their tribulation clouds absorbed before they finished advancing to the Immortal King realm. Wouldn't that mean that they still needed to continue their tribulation? However, looking at overwhelming heavenly tribulation clouds in the sky, sensing the endless aura of death and annihilation that settled over this world, they were alarmed and anxious. What kind of heavenly tribulation was this? Yet, if they were to flee, they would never advance to the Immortal King realm in their lifetime. Their paths would stop here. In the future, they would only be able to slowly wait for their longevity to run out and their death to descend. That was even more frightening than instant death. Hence, countless experts looked toward the core of the cloud, wanting to see what was going on. Suddenly, a crack of lightning split the world and a thunderous boom rang out, splitting people's eardrums. Seeing this scene, countless people lost their sight momentarily. As the tribulation clouds in the sky slowly parted, all that remained were Long Chen and Kun Tu's tribulation clouds. Those two tribulation clouds had just separated when something that terrified countless people occurred. The two tribulation clouds actually crashed against each other like shooting stars. Chapter 3774 Apocalyptic Boom. Even when everyone was prepared, countless people fainted from the impact. The world whined the moment these two tribulation clouds clashed, as they emitted endless lightning and a power that almost split heaven and earth in two. Endless runes roared through the clouds as if they were fighting, trying to suppress the other. The tribulation clouds clashed seven times, causing countless experts to scream in pain and terror. Blood poured out of their seven orifices. No matter what they tried, they couldn't block the shockwave. They felt completely powerless. The thunderous sound penetrated deep into their souls. Millions of people directly died, and their corpses fell into the heavenly river Blood Sea. Their tribulations had yet to even start before they were gone. There were a total of 9 clashes before the two tribulation clouds stopped clashing with each other. Then they saw the tribulation cloud belonging to Kun Tu slowly merge into Long Chen's tribulation cloud. It was like it had finally submitted. At that moment, Kun Tu's expression completely changed. "Impossible! This is impossible!" Kun Tu roared furiously. His voice shook the 9 heavens. He could not believe that his own heavenly tribulation would be inferior to Long Chen's. Countless experts appeared within this core region. Most were from the demonic beast race, but there were others present as well. At this moment, that underworld eye giant appeared, along with the terrifying beast cultivator. Many experts who had been attacked by the demonic beast race but were still safe and sound showed up now. They looked at Long Chen and Kun Tu in shock. As their heavenly tribulations had all been devoured, they felt resentful about it. But seeing the clashing of the two tribulations, they chose to just spectate. Kunpeng was a name that instilled fear in all of them. It was a symbol of unparalleled divine power. Hence, to see a human actually fighting a Kunpeng's heavenly tribulation was truly shocking. Even more shocking was that the Kunpeng's tribulation actually lost a human's tribulation. It wasn't just Kun too who couldn't believe it. The others couldn't either. In the end, the final two tribulation clouds merged into a single enormous cloud. This giant tribulation cloud then slowly revolved, emitting a terrifying pressure. At that moment, everyone's hair instantly stood on end, and a terrifying sensation of death filled their heart. Boom! All of a sudden, a saber light exploded in the heavens, attacking the heavenly tribulation. As a result, a giant hole was torn through the enormous cloud. From that cloud, it was possible to see just how dense the cloud was, which caused them all despair. The heavenly tribulation was enraged and began to rumble. After that, the roars of prehistoric beasts could be heard. Their voices almost tore apart people's souls. "I don't like wasting time on your warm-up or whatever. Let's get right into it." Long Chen then attacked the heavenly tribulation two more times. As a result, these two attacks didn't even manage to pierce through the entire tribulation cloud. It was constantly growing thicker and stronger, but it did seem further incensed by Long Chen's attacks. Suddenly, the tribulation clouds quivered, and five colored swords thousands of miles long rained down from the heavens. The descent of these giant swords was as concentrated as a torrential rainstorm. They instantly covered the entire heavenly river blood sea. No, these terrifying swords were comparable to the attack of a divine venerate. Ordinary experts were completely unable to block them, let alone absorb them. "Long Chen, I won't let you off even as a ghost." Just the first wave of the attacks was already so terrifying. How was this a heavenly tribulation? This was simply heavenly punishment. Every bit of lightning was completely destructive, to the point where it couldn't be absorbed. Screams of despair rang out. The demonic beast races experts were quickly annihilated, killed without leaving a corpse. Only supreme experts were able to block these terrifying lightning swords. However, they were shocked to find that this lightning didn't just contain lightning. It contained the energy of all five elements: metal, wood, water, fire, and earth. Every one of these energies crazily tore into their physical bodies. If their heavenly tribulation was like a spring of growth, then Long Chen's heavenly tribulation was like a pool of fatal poison. This tribulation was clearly intent on killing all existences without leaving them a survival chance. "Save me." Ordinary experts begged to be saved and got close to the supreme experts. Luckily, those supreme experts didn't reject them. As long as they didn't threaten their safety in any way, these supreme experts didn't mind helping them. Despite that, the heavenly tribulation was now a scene of chaos and despair. Screams rang out wherever blood mist and lightning mixed. This was the overture of a slaughter. The demonic beast races experts quickly formed into groups for their own safety. Those that were unable to find a supreme expert to hide under died to the heavenly tribulation. Under these five-colored lightning swords, even the strongest of the non-supreme experts were only able to block two before being killed if they couldn't get the protection of someone else. These five-colored lightning swords were too concentrated. There was practically no opening between them, leaving people without time to rest. At this time, the underworld eye giant's power was fully displayed. Those lightning swords simply shattered on contact with his body, unable to harm him in the slightest. The beast cultivator was also terrifying. His manifestation appeared and those lightning swords were destroyed by it. He simply stood there without moving. The other experts of the other races that had managed to come here were also able to survive without a hitch. Those who dared to sneak into this forbidden land of the demonic beast clearly possessed immense power. It was only the demonic beast race's experts that were thrown into chaos. Seeing this scene, the supreme experts of the demonic beast race spread out to protect their comrades and had no time to deal with the non-demonic beast experts. Those experts also didn't bother attacking the demonic beasts. They just coldly watched Long Chen and Kun too. "Boss, I see Wang Tianhao. He's hiding in the distance," transmitted Jiang Lei suddenly. Jiang Lei was also undergoing tribulation. As a lightning cultivator and with the experience that Lei Linger had transmitted to him, his supreme blood simply erupted and formed a lightning blood domain around him. The lightning that landed on him was simply absorbed. No one was targeting him or even looking at him. Hence, he started to circulate his thunder force to probe the surroundings and inadvertently noticed Wang Tianhao. Jiang Lei didn't know Wang Tiangao, but Long Chen had shown him the images of Wang Tiangao, Long Kinian, Jai Wuming, the nine underworld Liuacha, Yin Changsheng, and the others. At the very least, Jiang Lei had to know that they were mortal enemies and needed to be mentally prepared. Jiang Lei hadn't noticed Wang Tianhao at first because the latter had hidden so well. It was only when Jiang Lei used his spiritual strength and thunder force to check around that his spiritual perception grasped Wang Tianhao's existence. "This little fellow has also come. That's good. Ignore him for now. He's useful to me," responded Long Chen. Long Chen's gaze was locked onto Kun Tu, and likewise, Kun Tu's attention was also locked onto him. His wings were fully spread, covering the majority of the sky. Countless lightning swords fell on his back and shattered, their power directly absorbed. In fact, the power of Long Chen's heavenly tribulation could only be partially absorbed by most experts. After all, they needed to reject the parts that contained poisonous elements. But Kun Tu was able to directly absorb it just like Long Chen. Clearly, just like Long Chen, he was not an existence that the heavenly Taos favored. That tempered his talent to directly absorb heavenly tribulation. As for Lei Linger, she had long since been prepared for this feast. Hence, she had split into billions of bodies spread throughout every corner of this space, silently absorbing the lightning with all her might. All of a sudden, a flame ring appeared behind Long Chen. Kun Tu's gaze instantly turned icy cold, and he folded his wings, preparing for battle. Chapter 3775. Heo Linger conveniently benefits the moment. Long Chen's flame divine ring appeared. Kun Tu entered his combat state. Killing intent overflowed from his eyes, but they also contained a hint of fear. Previously, he and Long Chen had been struck by the divine light at the same time and been seriously injured. Kun Tu's injury was clearly lighter, though. After all, he was a true Kunpeng. His physical body was his greatest talent. Despite Long Chen's injuries clearly being worse than his, Kun Tu hadn't directly attacked. He was finally afraid. However, he wasn't afraid of Long Chen but of the many experts in the surroundings. The current him could no longer look down on Long Chen. Although he still had confidence in being able to kill Long Chen, he also knew that Long Chen would fight back with all his power before his death. In other words, even if he could kill Long Chen, he would have to pay a price. If this happened, then he would be further injured, and the experts of the other races might take advantage of that moment to attack. No matter how confident in himself he was, he wouldn't dare to face so many terrifying experts while he was seriously injured. That was why, despite knowing that this was his best chance to kill Long Chen, he still hadn't attacked. But when this flame ring appeared behind Long Chen, he jumped, thinking that Long Chen was preparing to fight. However, after summoning the flame divine ring, Long Chen didn't do anything else. A white-robed maiden sat within the flame divine ring. It was Heo Linger. Heo Linger was forming hand seals and chanting within the divine ring. She was actually chanting the first part of the Nirvana scripture. If it was before, Heulinger's spiritual strength would be insufficient to utilize the Nirvana scripture on her own. But after Bingpo gave Heulinger her source, energy, Heulinger underwent a complete transformation. She was now capable of independently using a portion of the Nirvana scripture. As she chanted, the lightning of the world quivered slightly. Flames actually separated from the lightning runes and merged into Heulinger's body. It was because this heavenly tribulation lightning contained the power of the five elements. As Heulinger had used up a great deal of her energy when she unleashed the world extermination flame lotus, she could borrow the power of this heavenly tribulation to replenish that spent energy. However, the flame energy in this lightning couldn't be directly absorbed. It was only after the lightning swords shattered that they became available. Bit by bit, flame runes were pulled toward her. With the nourishment of this flame energy, Heulinger was revitalized and the flame ring grew. What Heulinger hadn't expected was for the flame energy of this tribulation to be even purer than she had imagined. Her lost source energy was rapidly recovering. She almost cried out in delight. "Stay calm, stay calm. Conceal your true power. A fierce battle will be fought soon," warned Long Chen hastily, afraid that she was going to get crazy. Heulinger hastily suppressed her exploding aura. She simply chanted the Nirvana scripture and absorbed this energy, compressing it into tiny flame spheres and sending them into the primal chaos space as storage. This flame energy was amazingly pure and could be directly absorbed without digestion. Once she absorbed it, it instantly merged with her, transforming into source energy. If she absorbed too much, there would be no way for her to keep her aura suppressed. Hence, in order to not appear too flashy, she compressed this energy for future storage. However, even when she didn't directly absorb this energy, the process of the compression still caused her to absorb a bit of its power automatically. 90% was compressed and stored, but 10% was automatically absorbed. She couldn't stop it. Heulinger didn't know if these flames simply had this characteristic innately or if it was due to the Nirvana scripture's power drawing them to her. In any case, it was her first time encountering such a good thing. She gathered as much of this flame energy as she could. Long Chen simply summoned a flame divine ring and had Heulinger chanting inside of it. As it didn't look like anything particularly special, Kantu calmed down. His greatest worry was Long Chen realizing that he was definitely dead and suddenly launching a suicidal attack on him. Long Chen coldly looked at Kantu. He was currently circulating the primal chaos space's energy to help him recover. The wood foundation divine trees finally quivered. In the past, they had so much life energy that when he needed to recover, the amount of life energy he took was so minuscule that it didn't cause any change in them. However, this time, his injuries were so severe that the leaves of the wood foundation divine trees finally started to turn dark yellow. Long Chen knew that his current body was between the Divine Lord and Immortal King realms. It naturally took more energy. Furthermore, the attack he had just been struck by was truly bizarre. This injury of his was requiring a terrifying amount of life energy to heal. However, he wasn't afraid of this kind of injury. The only thing to worry about was a grand Tao injury that even the primal chaos space's energy was powerless against. Although that pillar of divine light had been terrifying, the primal chaos space's energy was still effective in healing it. That meant that it wasn't grand Tao power. It was very likely the combined power of those billion beast venerates. As long as it wasn't heavenly Tao energy, Long Chen wasn't afraid of it. Long Chen's wounds were recovering at a speed visible to the naked eye. At the same time, Kantu's recovery speed was not inferior to his. Seeing their physical bodies recover so quickly, countless experts gasped. This terrifying heavenly tribulation was something that even supreme experts needed to focus all of their power on surviving. But these two were completely ignoring it and actually calmly recovering within it. When an incense stick's worth of time passed, things were no longer chaotic. The supreme demonic beasts were protecting the other demonic beasts that were still alive. Because of this, they finally had a chance to gather themselves and join forces to attack the lightning swords. After all, only by destroying the lightning swords could the lightning runes be absorbed. Otherwise, just by dodging, they wouldn't be able to absorb anything, and then they wouldn't be able to refine the blood essence Kai hanging in the air. The reason they had risked their lives to undergo tribulation here was to absorb this energy. In order to completely transform themselves, they could only go all out. However, before this tribulation started, there was an uncountable number of demonic beasts here. Just the amount that a single person could see was over a trillion, let alone those that were further away. Now, though, they numbered no more than 100 million. It was only thanks to the tens of thousands of supreme experts that they were still alive. Otherwise, they'd have long since fallen to the lightning swords. After the chaos, they began testing the lightning swords. One reason was so that they could absorb more lightning, while another reason was to lighten the pressure on the supreme experts protecting them, giving them a chance to breathe. However, just as they began to absorb this lightning, the five colored lightning swords suddenly changed color. They turned black and pierced down with the aura of death. Boom! A supreme demonic beast slashed his sword at a black lightning sword, only for that black sword to explode, transforming into a giant black lightning flower. Absorbing the impact, the supreme expert was directly blasted into the distance. As for the other demonic beasts that were being guarded by him, they were devoured by that black lightning flower, turning into nothingness. No. Seeing that, the demonic beast race's experts cried out in despair. Chapter 3776, each harboring their own motives, the five colored lightning swords turned black and contained endless destructive auras. When they fell amongst the people around, they suddenly exploded, unleashing violent power that even shattered the laws of the heavenly Taos. The black swords exploded one after another. Every explosion formed a ripple of death. Other than the energies of metal, wood, water, fire, and earth, there was also the power of annihilation. It was capable of even destroying the laws of heaven and earth. Before this, the lightning swords were straight-line attacks. But now, they became bombs. Every lightning sword unleashed a domain of death. The demonic beast's experts were no longer able to resist. Even their weapons were destroyed by the black lightning. As a result, they were wiped out of existence. Their bodies and souls were annihilated. Even supreme experts had difficulty surviving now. As they had no ability to look after others anymore, this heavenly tribulation instantly became a black hell. It was like the slaughterhouse of the heavenly Taos, dark and bloody. Even the divine venerates of the demonic beast watching from outside were shocked. What kind of heavenly tribulation is this? It doesn't give people any chance of survival. It clearly wants to kill everyone. They had lived countless years and had seen all kinds of violent heavenly tribulations. However, those were all simply trials with high chances of success. Those kinds of tribulations only wiped out the weak, leaving the strong to survive. However, the actual tribulation didn't have the slightest life energy to it. There was only endless destructive energy. Let alone those disciples, even old fellows like them, were terrified by it. They couldn't see any hope of surviving. This can't continue. Kill that human! Suddenly, one of the divine venerates shouted loudly, his voice penetrating deep into the heavenly tribulation. The other experts outside looked at him in horror. Boom! As a result, A streak of light flew out of the heavenly tribulation, striking the person that shouted. This person was a divine venerate, but having been locked down by the heavenly tribulation, he had no chance of survival. He was blown apart. His body exploded. But very quickly, another figure appeared. It was the person who had just been killed. Seeing this, those experts around him sighed with relief. This person had sacrificed a clone to shout. But it was worth it. That person's shout had truly frightened them just now. It was not permitted to randomly talk during tribulations. One wrong word and the wrath of the heavens would descend upon them. However, just then, another spear of lightning came out of the heavenly tribulation, crossing a great distance to stab through that person's body. Everyone was shocked. The clone had been killed, and that should have been enough to satisfy karma. But in front of countless horrified gazes, that divine venerate was once more slain. This time, no other body appeared. He was truly dead. This heavenly tribulation is too terrifying. Not even clones can trick it. They were all horrified. They had never even heard of such a heavenly tribulation. Heavenly punishment was not so gullible. Any interference in the heavenly punishment came at a price. Hence, under normal circumstances, no one would dare to take the risk of provoking heavenly tribulation. However, in the past, some people had shouted toward a heavenly tribulation, and if they had a clone, they were always able to sacrifice it in order to placate the heavenly tribulation. But this time, this move failed. Even the true body was slain with the clone. Countless people turned green with terror. Fortunately, this person was slain in one move. If he survived, the heavenly tribulation would instantly go from an immortal king tribulation to a divine venerate tribulation. Then everyone, including them, would be covered by the tribulation and killed. If so many divine venerates were to undergo collective tribulation, this part of the world would be wiped out of existence, and all life forms on it would be destroyed. Everyone attack Long Chen. As long as he's killed, the level of the heavenly tribulation will plummet. Otherwise, we'll all die. Suddenly, a shark shriek rang out. This one shout caused countless experts to look at Long Chen hostily. Wang Tianhao. As soon as Long Chen heard this voice, he knew who it was. This fellow was hidden in the dark. He actually thought that Long Chen hadn't noticed and encouraged the demonic beasts to attack him. After that, Long Chen's Minghong saber appeared in his hand. Lightning flowed around him, and his gaze swept across everyone. He coldly said, "He is right. If you kill me, this heavenly tribulation will lower a level and become a Kunpeng tribulation. Perhaps more people will survive that way. If you want my life, come. Everyone attack together. Don't waste any more time, or the heavenly tribulation will keep growing stronger. It doesn't matter how strong he is, if we all attack together, he's definitely dead." The demonic beast races experts roared and began to approach Long Chen. However, they quickly paused, feeling dumbfounded. They found that only a very small number of people were actually moving. The majority of people weren't budging. These demonic beasts stared in disbelief at those experts. Kun Tu hadn't moved, and neither was the underworld eye giant. The experts of the various races were all still. Even amongst the demonic beast race, the majority were only focusing on blocking the heavenly tribulation. They seemed to have no intention of attacking. The weak are always the stepping stones of the strong, so no one cares about your deaths. We just want to see what kind of existence the strongest heavenly tribulation is. Heavenly tribulation is a trial where the weak are eliminated. The stronger the tribulation, the greater the benefits. Heavenly tribulation is always fair. As long as you can live, the more you pay, the more you gain. Ants like you should shut your mouths. You can only represent yourselves. Don't try to tell others what to do. If you can't do anything yourselves, then just die. At this time, the beast cultivator spoke. His voice was like that of thousands merged into one. It echoed repeatedly, and even within this tribulation, it spread far and wide. When the demonic beasts heard that, the ones that had started moving fell into despair. Their only hope was for Long Chen to die and the heavenly tribulation to weaken. That was their only chance of survival. However, from the viewpoint of the real experts, they only hoped for the tribulation to grow even stronger. That would allow them to gain even more benefits. Whether it was the five colored lightning swords or the black lightning swords, they were helping the real experts advance immensely. They were shocked by how beneficial it was. It was completely different from when they underwent tribulation in the past. Absorbing this lightning was allowing them to absorb more of the essence blood Kai spread throughout the heavenly river blood sea, strengthening their physical bodies. Furthermore, as more people died here, there were fewer people competing with them for this energy. In fact, even amongst the powerful members of the demonic beast race, they were hoping for more people to die so that they could gain more benefits. The weaker ones, who had no confidence in passing this tribulation, had no hope now. Their thinking was the opposite of what the majority was thinking. There was no chance of it becoming a reality. As for Long Chen, he remained fearless from the start. It seemed as if he had long since expected all this. He simply held the Ming Hong saber. He didn't put it away, because he knew that the true battle was about to start. Just then, the tribulation split open. Giant lightning chains descended from above the nine heavens, piercing through the void and entering the blood sea. Following that, giant figures were dragged out of the blood sea. When they saw those figures, even Kun Tu's pupils shrank to the point of a needle Navaloon. Come those are. The beast venerates skeletons. The jaws of the demonic beast race's experts dropped. They all quivered in terror. Chapter 3777, playing big one mountain-sized figure after another was dragged out of the blood sea by the chains of the heavenly tribulation. People were so terrified that their souls almost fled their bodies. Could it be? It wasn't just the blood sea. The lightning chains pierced through the void, directly tearing through the land outside the sea and dragging corpses out. Even the demonic beasts outside the tribulation were horrified and didn't even dare to move. They just allowed those lightning chains to drag the corpses out of the ground. When the heavenly tribulations bound the skeletons, thunder force poured through their bones. After that, as lightning runes appeared on top of the bones, their innate runes were also activated. All of a sudden, one of them raised its head and roared. Its roar shook the sky. It then spread its bone wings, and flames actually burst out of it, igniting the dome of the heavens. It was actually revived by the thunder force. It's the immemorial divine phoenix race. A supreme expert cried out in shock. Although that beast was already reduced to a skeleton, based on its aura, it was still possible to recognize its identity. The divine phoenix opened its mouth. Lightning and flames mixed and burst out of it, striking the experts undergoing tribulation. However, just as those flames flew out, they transformed into runes and floated toward Qiolinger. Qiolinger was chanting the Nirvana scripture, and the world's flame energy was gathering toward her. Despite that, the lightning from the divine phoenix's attack still sent several supreme experts flying. The weaker demonic beasts under their protection were instantly obliterated. One ancient demonic beast after another revived, their roars shaking the heavens. They began to attack everyone undergoing tribulation. How can this be? Seeing all those skeletons attacking, even supreme experts were terrified. Those were their ancestors, but they actually had to face them like this. Spit the heavens, one. Long Chen pierced through the head of one of those ancient beasts, directly destroying the crystal core in its head. Boom! Just as Long Chen had expected, the crystal core was the true source of their power. Once the core was destroyed, the skeleton exploded, disintegrating into powder. Lightning runes within it exploded. What pure thunder force! Lei Linger was delighted. Once one of these ancient beasts was killed, the thunder force driving their movements was released. She then felt her power crazily soaring just from absorbing this energy. You keep silently absorbing the energy. Keep a distance from Kuntu, the underworld eye giant, and that beast cultivator. Don't be noticed by them, implored Long Chen cautiously. If Lei Linger didn't get close to them, they would have great difficulty noticing her. She had transformed into millions and millions of tiny lightning dragons hidden within the void, and those lightning dragons secretly absorbed the runes that were exposed. Reaping without sowing was far more efficient compared to destroying the runes herself. Suddenly, Long Chen's heart shook. He instinctively dodged to the side, and a lightning sword passed through the space he had just been in. The lightning sword pierced a hole through the void. Unfortunately, two supreme demonic beasts were unable to dodge in time and were devoured by that hole. They cried out, trying to escape the black hole. But the void sealed shut, and their figures vanished. Everyone was horrified by this. Just then, the beast that unleashed that lightning sword charged at Long Chen. This giant beast was surrounded by lightning spikes. It was like a hedgehog with two heads. However, due to the lack of flesh and blood, it was difficult to tell what exactly this life form was. Even so, the attack it had just released was truly terrifying. Not good. Seeing it rushing toward him with its body rapidly inflating, Long Chen's expression suddenly changed. As lightning wings appeared on his back, he swung his saber and retreated. Boom! Long Chen's saber struck the hedgehog, causing it to explode. But its spikes shot out in every direction like heaven-piercing spears. Incoming, tens of thousands of spikes flew through the air. In the chaos, there was nowhere to dodge. There were other immemorial demonic beasts around as well. The lightning spikes raged. It was unknown how many experts were struck by them and turned to dust. Even supreme experts were unable to resist. It wasn't just supreme experts that were killed by that attack. Even the immemorial demonic beasts struck by those spikes were also blasted away. Several of them had their heads pierced and thus died. After they were destroyed, their own innate runes would scatter. Sometimes people could even see undamaged, complete runes in their core. Those complete runes drove the demonic beasts crazy with desire. They went crazy, fighting over those runes. They were even willing to gamble their lives away. It had to be known that those runes were these beast venerates' innate divine abilities. If the experts here could grasp them, they would have limitless potential. And even if they couldn't absorb it, by carving it into their souls, perhaps they could use it to peer into the secrets of the immemorial divine arts. Even if they couldn't benefit, they could sell that rune for immense wealth. Perhaps they could even exchange it for a divine rune that they could use. Thus, these runes were priceless treasures that drove them crazy. Because of it, they completely forgot about the threat of death. These ancestors are under the control of the heavenly tribulation. They are no longer family. Everyone, kill them and take their runes, shouted one person taking the lead. However, people only heard the voice and not the speaker. In the chaos, people thought that it was done by a demonic beast, but it was actually shouted by the hidden Wang Tianhao. Wang Tianhao was very sinister. He had a heavenly lightning body, and just like Lei Linger, he was hidden within the lightning and void, silently profiting. He occasionally shouted a few words to encourage the demonic beasts. Also, he intentionally changed his voice. Even his spiritual fluctuations imitated the demonic beast race, so he had the confidence to hide from everyone. Unfortunately, he had no idea that he had long since been noticed by Jiang Lei. Furthermore, even if Jiang Lei hadn't noticed him, there was no way that Lei Linger wouldn't notice him. Following this reminder, these demonic beasts went even crazier. These inheritance runes were even more important than their lives. If they could obtain one, then even if their race was incompatible with it, they could always exchange it with others. Pill. Those demonic beasts went crazy. Their manifestations erupted, and their blood kiss ignited. They no longer held back at all. They went all out against these terrifying immemorial demonic beasts. Wielding the Minghong saber, Long Chen activated his divine ring and his six-star battle armor. He was also in danger right now. Hundreds of immemorial demonic beasts were attacking him. Moreover, Long Chen found that these immemorial demonic beasts were treating him differently. When they attacked others, their attacks weren't as ferocious. It was only against him that they seemed to go crazy, even willing to self-detonate just to bring him down. That gave him a bad feeling. It seemed that he had played a bit too overboard this time. He might not be able to take it back. Worst of all, Long Chen sensed that Kun Tu's aura was crazily rising. This heavenly tribulation was immensely beneficial to him. This is no good. You will die in that Kun Pang brat's hands like this. I'll teach you the swallow the heavens, devour the earth divine ability. You have to pass this tribulation. Suddenly, the dragon expert's voice rang out in Long Chen's head. Chapter 3778, dealing with the present predicament, Long Chen was delighted to hear the dragon expert's voice, but he was a bit disappointed by what it said. You're saying that I'll die fighting Kun Tu? Long Chen couldn't believe his ears. Although he wasn't unbeatable, he was confident that he could beat anyone in the same realm. That was not conceit, but confidence that came from winning through endless fights and struggles. For the dragon expert to say that Long Chen would die fighting Kun Tu, his competitive spirit was instantly ignited. If I say yes, will you immediately throw your life away to beat him? Asked the dragon expert. I don't believe that I'll lose to him, said Long Chen, eyeing the distant Kun Tu. If you were to fight him, you would be evenly matched. Who lives and who dies would be up to fate. But as time passes, he is absorbing the essence blood here, stimulating his physical body. His power is continuously climbing. As for you, what have you obtained? Asked the dragon expert. Long Chen was shocked to find that when the lightning entered his body, there was no noticeable improvement in his strength. At the start, he had assumed that it was due to the difficulty in the tribulation being too low. Hence, he had assumed that there would be a better effect later. However, it seemed that the dragon expert was saying that there was a problem. In your past tribulations, although the heavenly tribulations wanted to kill you, you would still get some benefits. That is a law of the heavenly tribulation that cannot be changed. Even my dragon races, heavenly tribulations, or the Kun Peng races tribulations bring benefits to the one undergoing tribulation. But your current tribulation is different. It is not benefiting you. Your heavenly tribulation has completely changed into pure destruction without nourishment. The moment you said that you would topple this world and create your own world, it was said that your heavenly tribulations would no longer bring you any benefits. The heavenly tribulation will only seek to kill you, said the dragon expert. I don't understand. I've said similar things before, but the heavenly tribulations never changed. Why is it different now? Asked Long Chen, his head buzzing. That was because, in the past, you didn't have the necessary power, so the heavenly tribulation ignored your words. But now, you are infected by too much karma. You have started to gain the power to defy the heavens, and the heavenly tribulation is afraid of you. Even if you manage to pass this tribulation, you will at most find that your realm has broken through. But unlike before, you will not be able to use the Thunder Force to temper your body and have it go through a complete transformation. Others will advance by leaps and bounds, while you will be stuck where you are. Now, do you accept what I said about you dying to that Kunpeng brat? Asked the dragon expert. Long Chen's heart sank. If this was true, if he couldn't benefit from the heavenly tribulation, it wouldn't be long before he died to a heavenly tribulation. By dragon race, Kunpeng race, and some other mixed race experts possess the will to defy the heavens. We live and defy the heavens in order to break through the restrictions of the laws and rules of the world, allowing us to be free. Although our heavenly tribulations are terrifying, with a high chance of death, we will always be transformed if we pass the tribulation. Our power will grow explosively. It is different for you now. You do not wish to be free or be above the law. No, you wish to destroy it. You want to create your own laws. The current you is a kill on sight existence to the heavenly tribulation. It will use any means necessary to kill you. It is due to this that the Kunpeng race's tribulation was devoured by your tribulation, and why even the skeletons of the demonic beast race were used by the heavenly tribulation. Moreover, this is just the start. An even more terrifying tribulation is oncoming. Although your lightning spirit will benefit immensely, no matter how great her power grows, it is not your power. That is why you have to think of a way to benefit from this as well, said the dragon expert. Then, many thanks, senior. Long Chen hadn't expected things to progress to this point. The heavenly tribulation was no longer letting him grow, but Kun Tu was advancing rapidly within it. Just like that, it was definite that Long Chen wouldn't be a match for Kun Tu in the future. After all, without advancing to the Immortal King realm, he wouldn't dare to summon the seven-star battle armor. The seven-star battle armor was so powerful that he was afraid his body wouldn't be able to endure it. Originally, he was hoping for his physical body to be upgraded through this tribulation. That would be the foundation for condensing the seven-star battle armor. But this sudden change made him panic. I don't know if this will work, but your current crisis must be dealt with. I will transmit the swallow the heavens, devour the earth divine ability, said the dragon expert. I already know it. Long Chen suddenly thought of this technique. Dragon Bone Evil Moon had taught it to him. That's nothing more than a superficial version. The true swallow the heavens, devour the earth does not require swallowing the target into the stomach. Don't argue. There's almost no more time, said the dragon expert a bit anxiously. Long Chen hastily focused on listening. After that, dragon scales suddenly covered his hands and he formed hand seals. As he did so, golden mist floated out of his body, transforming into a giant dragon behind him. It was a five-clawed golden dragon. When it slowly opened its mouth, heaven and earth collapsed into a giant vortex. As a result, the explosive power of heaven and earth was devoured by the dragon mouth like a whale inhaling water. The golden dragon swallowed the heavens and devoured the earth. Meanwhile, Long Chen's body began to crackle as endless energy poured into him. It felt like his body would explode. This energy was extremely chaotic. There was Thunder Force Essence Blood Energy, Blood Soul Energy, as well as various runes and fragments. They were all absorbed into his body. It felt like a landslide was rolling inside his body. This explosive power then poured through his limbs and bones. His skin began to bulge as the power boiled. Senior, will this really work? This energy is polluting my dragon blood, exclaimed Long Chen. At this time, such a thing can't be bothered with. Staying alive is more important. As for those impurities, it should. In a bit, you'll understand. Intense pain racked Long Chen's body. These violent powers were not nourishing his body. it was as if they were trying to destroy him. Long Chen hastily circulated his true dragon essence blood, absorbing those mixed energies and expelling the damaging portion. How foolish! Pure essence blood is being ruined by you. Long Chen, I overestimated you. You're an idiot. When Kun Tu saw Long Chen absorbing the energy of heaven and earth, Kun Tu's expression sank. Although he looked down on Long Chen, he was very interested in Long Chen's true dragon essence blood. In this world, the only thing worthy of him devouring it was true dragon essence blood. However, by absorbing all of these energies, Long Chen was mixing the true dragon essence blood with the aura of the billion beast venerates. As a result, the true dragon essence blood would be contaminated, and Kun Tu could no longer devour it. Kun Tu possessed the purest Kun Peng bloodline, so he naturally wouldn't devour other bloodlines. He was only absorbing the thunder force and constantly strengthening his physical body. Thus, seeing Long Chen absorb all these mixed bloodlines, he was shocked, enraged, and aggrieved. He had long since viewed Long Chen's essence blood as his treasure. Suddenly, explosive sounds came from Long Chen's body. Violent blood Kai energy soared like raging lava and nourished his body. After that, his physical body rapidly grew stronger, and his aura shook the void. The pressure that he gave off grew increasingly terrifying, causing everyone to jump in shock. Suddenly, the immemorial demonic beasts roared in unison. Their withered eyes suddenly lit up with a strange light. Despite being nothing more than skeletons, they seemed to have been bestowed with spirits. Long Chen, return my life! Suddenly, one of those immemorial demonic beasts spoke and charged at Long Chen, its sharp claws tearing through the void. An overwhelming resentful air came from it. Chapter 3779, Soul Corpse Reincarnation. The immemorial demonic beast actually spoke. That made everyone jump. Although these demonic beasts were terrifying, they were still nothing more than corpses controlled by the heavenly tribulation. But now, it was as if these immemorial demonic beasts had come back to life. Resentful auras erupted out of them as they attacked Long Chen. They were looking at Long Chen as if he was the one who had killed their fathers. Soul reincarnation into a corpse. Long Chen was shocked. He then saw a humanoid figure above that immemorial demonic beast. It seemed to be a human Yuan spirit that was glaring at him resentfully. Sensing his aura, Long Chen estimated that it was a powerful supreme heavenly genius. This immemorial demonic beast's corpse had somehow merged with this heavenly genius's soul. At this moment, the runes on the skeleton fully lit up, and it attacked with an apocalyptic aura. The others were all horrified by this sight. Such a phenomenon was not even recorded in historical texts. It was absolutely bizarre. It was a bull-shaped life form with hooves stamping through the air. Its horns lit up, and it smashed through the world like a meteor, instantly reaching Long Chen. At this moment, the veins on Long Chen's arms bulged like wiggling serpents. After absorbing so much of that mixed essence blood energy, Long Chen's power had crazily risen. He slashed the Ming Hong saber fiercely. Boom! A heaven-shaking explosion shook the entire world. A giant bull horn then fell to the ground. Long Chen had severed it. As for the rest of the bull, it was sent tumbling back by Long Chen's attack. What power! Navalun Kam Sigu Jurati Shunya M. Long Chen was shocked. He hadn't expected his power to suddenly rise to such a level. His My True Dragon races swallow the heavens, devour the earth divine ability, something that you can imagine. After devouring the essence blood of so many demonic beasts, although you've contaminated your dragon blood, your power has now risen by over 10 times in this short time, said the dragon expert proudly. Boom! Long Chen was about to reply when he heard another huge explosion, and a terrifying force blew him back. that all life form had actually self-detonated. As a result, the supreme heavenly genius's soul vanished along with it. That person's soul essence had been merged into the corpse by the heavenly tribulation. The supreme expert himself knew that he was already dead. The heavenly tribulation had only bestowed upon him a chance for vengeance. Seeing that he couldn't kill Long Chen, he directly self-detonated just to harm Long Chen. More and more of the immemorial demonic beasts were bestowed with souls. Their auras completely changed. As they possessed their own conscience now, they immediately attacked Long Chen. Nothing more than a group of dead, resentful spirits. Why would I be afraid? Long Chen held the Minghong saber. Sensing the endless power within his body, his battle intent soared. The Minghong saber cried out as it attacked. One immemorial demonic beast after another was sent tumbling back, while some of them were directly killed by a single attack. Long Chen's body was still swelling. His legs were twice as thick as they usually were, and every single one of his movements caused his blood kai to roar. It was as if he had an inexhaustible source of power. After slaying those demonic beasts, Long Chen absorbed even more essence blood. His physical body was rapidly strengthening. This violent blood kai was difficult to control, but the immense power made Long Chen feel like the ruler of the 10,000 Daos. Feeling great, he fought more and more fiercely. No matter how those immemorial demonic beasts attacked him, they were sent flying back one by one. Long Chen absorbed the essence blood, while Lei Linger absorbed the lightning. As for Huo Linger, she absorbed the flame runes in the lightning. They were all growing rapidly. Suddenly, the void split open, and a pair of giant wings rose to the heavens. Countless immemorial demonic beasts were sent flying. Some of their bodies exploded, transforming into lightning runes. Kun Tu! Startled cries rang out. Kun Tu suddenly unleashed such an attack. His wings were like blades, slaughtering those demonic beasts. Kun Tu then extended a claw, directly crushing one of those demonic beasts. Everyone was shocked by this. He annihilated such a terrifying existence without the slightest effort. Kun Tu's interference drew a mass of immemorial demonic beasts against him. Even those being controlled by supreme heavenly geniuses attacked him. He was actually attacking them even faster than Long Chen. Everyone was shocked by his immense power. However, people quickly reacted. Boom! The next to join in was the beast cultivator. He summoned his manifestation, and countless wild beasts roared within it. As wings spread on his back, his hands transformed into sharp claws. After that, horns grew out of his head, and tusks extended out of his mouth. Most terrifying of all, a sharp tail also grew out of his butt. At the same time, patches appeared on his skin. Some areas were furry, some were scaled. There were even some strange bone spurs on some parts of his skin. He became a completely strange life form. He let out a roar. It was like a tiger and a lion's roar combined, and an explosive sound wave spread throughout the sky. With a flap of his wings, he shot toward one of those immemorial demonic beasts like a bolt of lightning. Boom! Suddenly, he opened his mouth, and a red light shot out like a sharp sword, piercing through his target's head. That immemorial demonic beast was killed in a single blow, transforming into runes. The beast cultivator's body then quivered. The immemorial demonic beast's runes, whether it was the essence blood runes, lightning runes, or inheritance runes, were all devoured by him. After seeing him join in as well, everyone realized that they were fighting over the immemorial demonic beasts. Although these immemorial demonic beasts were terrifying, their bodies were treasures. Killing them could rapidly strengthen an expert. Although they looked to be endless, there were only a billion. If this continued and they didn't join in, they would all be devoured by Long Chen, Kun Tu, and the others. Such a heavenly tribulation was unprecedented, so its benefits were clearly insane. As long as they could pass this tribulation, they would soar in this world. This was their only chance to completely change their fates. They could not let it slip by. Following the beast cultivator, the underworld eye giant also joined in. Black Kai swirled around his body, and his Warhammer's runes lit up. His body grew, and with a swing of his Warhammer, three immemorial demonic beasts were killed. Seeing that Kantu and the others were no longer holding back, the other experts also started going all out. Furious roars shook the heavens as they attacked the immemorial demonic beasts, absorbing the energy that they unleashed. As expected, the more they killed, the more energy they absorbed, and the stronger they grew. Whether it was demonic beasts or other races, they were driven crazy by this opportunity. All of a sudden, a lightning sword silently appeared. It was like a phantom, bizarrely killing the immemorial demonic beasts one by one. The lightning runes were devoured, but no one saw the wielder of the sword. "Get out of the way. I'm killing Long Chen. Don't force me." A supreme heavenly genius's soul within an immemorial demonic beast roared and charged at Long Chen. However, as a result, he was killed by supreme experts from his own race. "Bastards, you're going to kill your own people. Then don't blame me." Another possessed immemorial demonic beast roared and attacked a nearby demonic beast expert. Things descended into chaos. Chapter 3780, The Final Wave of Heavenly Tribulation. Originally, the possessed immemorial demonic beasts were only thinking of killing Long Chen. It was because the heavenly Daos had assigned them the mission of killing Long Chen. Furthermore, their soul essence was grasped by the heavenly Daos just as they died, so they still temporarily had their consciousness. They wanted to kill Long Chen for killing them. However, their fellow demonic beasts also wanted to kill them again to take their thunder force and essence blood energy. That enraged them, and they began to attack indiscriminately. Just like that, anyone who dared to stop them from killing Long Chen was assaulted with their full power. Everything descended into chaos. In order to gather more thunder force and essence blood energy, everyone went crazy. The energy within a single immemorial demonic beast was enough to cause their power to soar. Such an immense opportunity to get stronger would only come once in this lifetime, and they naturally wouldn't let it go. As Long Chen held the Minghong saber, his divine ring spun and his starry sea quivered. After that, strange marks appeared along the Minghong saber. These were the runes of those immemorial demonic beasts that he had slain. They somehow appear on the Minghong saber. At this moment, endless power gushed out of the Minghong saber. It seemed to descend into a crazed state. Bit by bit, this killing weapon's aura grew increasingly terrifying, like a devil breaking out of its seal. When it slashed down, it always killed an immemorial demonic beast. Even Long Chen was shocked. He was absorbing the essence blood of these immemorial demonic beasts, but the Minghong saber was obtaining just as many benefits as him. There was no way for Long Chen to absorb those runes into his blood. No matter how much essence blood he absorbed, his golden dragon blood, despite now only being 1/1000th of his total essence blood, still dominated everything. It was the general controlling the masses, and the new blood was unable to resist. Because of this, the runes were expelled outside of his body and entered the Minghong saber. The Minghong saber accepted them all, and countless marks appeared on it. The fragments of the immemorial demonic beast's inheritance runes were all absorbed by it, causing it to undergo an immense transformation. Its murderous aura grew increasingly dense. The Minghong saber grew increasingly powerful, while Long Chen was inhaling thunder force and essence blood. Originally, it was just his dragon blood-wielding power. But now countless bandits in the form of various essence bloods had joined in. Their individual power wasn't great, but they could form an immense army which was controlled by the dragon blood. This terrifying power even shocked Long Chen. As time passed, this army grew stronger and stronger until Long Chen felt his body starting to hurt. This immense army was finally starting to go out of his control. The stronger they grew, the more difficult controlling them was. Lei Linger, give me some power. Long Chen had no choice but to ask Lei Linger for aid. Lei Linger assented, and her thunder force poured through his veins, helping him control this new essence blood by destroying their old wills. It would make controlling them easier. The battle then continued to rage, and Long Chen resumed slaughtering the immemorial demonic beasts that reached him. In the distance, Kun Tu's wings flew through the air, blasting apart the immemorial demonic beasts. His killing speed was not at all inferior to Long Chen's. Furthermore, his aura was also growing stronger and stronger. Killing those immemorial demonic beasts grew increasingly easy for him. The underworld Eye Giant, the Beast Cultivator, and some other powerful heavenly geniuses were also at full power slaughtering those immemorial demonic beasts. This was truly a battlefield where the weak were eliminated. The experts grew increasingly powerful as they slaughtered the immemorial demonic beasts. But the weak, despite knowing that killing the immemorial demonic beasts would bring them endless benefits, were too weak to do so. In the end, they were simply killed. Of tens of thousands of supreme geniuses, only over 3,000 remained. It was because there were immense power differences between supreme geniuses. The ones remaining were all true experts. As they continued to kill, the endless army of immemorial demonic beasts gradually reached their end. Their numbers were finally shrinking. Boss, this heavenly tribulation might only have two waves. Should we kill Kun Tu first? Jiang Lei eyed the tribulation clouds that were growing sparse. Jiang Lei always remained not too far from Long Chen. That way, they would still be able to cooperate. At this moment, he didn't know how many immemorial demonic beasts he had killed himself. Furthermore, at this distance, some of the scattered lightning runes from the beasts killed by Long Chen were also devoured by Jiang Lei. Every inch of his skin was covered in lightning marks. His body had been tempered to a point that he couldn't imagine. Now, he even had the confidence to receive a world domain divine item's attack barehanded. An unprecedented power filled him with confidence. With the tribulation clouds growing sparse, it seemed that they were going to vanish. Hence, Jiang Lei's immediate thought was that they would be besieged by the demonic beasts again as soon as the tribulation was over, so it would be better to cut them down before the tribulation ended. Then they would only have to deal with the divine venerates outside. The heavenly tribulation won't have only two waves. That doesn't match their tempo. Although the laws of the heavenly Taos are different here and this place is special, causing the heavenly tribulation to change once more, based on my experience, there is at least one more wave. Don't be careless. Conserve your power, responded Long Chen. When it came to his tribulations, he didn't look at the tribulation clouds. He only trusted his own intuition. Another wave? Jiang Lei was shocked. If there really was another wave, then it would be even stronger than the last. But this wave had pushed so many people to their limit. If there was a stronger wave, wouldn't they all be wiped out? Many people seemed to be thinking the same thing as Jiang Lei, assuming that the heavenly tribulation would only have two waves. Seeing that the number of immemorial demonic beasts was shrinking, they unleashed all their power to gain more benefits before the tribulation ended. Just then, the sky darkened and a huge figure charged at Long Chen. Everyone was shocked. It was Kun Tu. Long Chen, time's almost up. Time for you to face your death. Kun 2's manifestation burst into existence, and the huge Kun appeared once more. Those immemorial demonic beasts nearby him were directly blown apart, I just the aura of this great Kun. What? Whether it was the demonic beasts or the other experts, they were all terrified. Kun 2 used just his manifestation to crush those immemorial demonic beasts. The heavenly tribulation wasn't even over, but his aura was more than 10 times greater than before. Such an advancement speed was absolutely terrifying. Long Chen was also startled. Compared to before, Kun 2 was like an entirely different person. It was no wonder the dragon expert had said that he might die in Kun 2's hands. Fortunately, Long Chen had also made huge gains, otherwise, he really wouldn't be a match for Kun 2 any longer. If he had gone through this tribulation normally, he'd have gained far too little. Time is almost up. No, we're still a bit off. Do you think my heavenly tribulation will end like this? You're too naive. Long Chen shook his head. At this moment, the tribulation clouds in the sky slowly faded away. There were still thousands of immemorial demonic beasts left, but they were quickly killed. However, people's expressions quickly changed. Even after killing all the immemorial demonic beasts, they hadn't advanced to the Immortal King realm. Just then, the seawater plummeted. In just a breath's time, this endless sea vanished, revealing a dry seabed. After that, the earth quivered. People saw lightning sparking within the land. Following that, the seabed split open and pillars of lightning soared into the heavens. The world became a lightning cage. As the seabed collapsed, one lightning-clad figure after another slowly flew out. When Long Chen saw those figures, his pupils shrank to the size of the point of a needle. This final heavenly tribulation is the 9-star heirs.